play?
Oh, yeah.
We are a violent chemistry.
What's up, everybody? It's Friday night, and you know what that means. It's time for an all-new Socially Awkward Studios. We got your dude, Steve-O. And me, I'm your boy, Fro-Yo. It's Friday night, the drinks are tight. Let's have some fun.
Cheers, bud.
Cheers to the oncoming... Ting.
Hey, everybody.
Wow, that was really good.
Thanks, man. Hey, everybody out there listening in the universe.
Welcome
to... My name is Matthew, and this is...
Steve-O.
There you go. Nice little rubato, dude. Hey, it's Friday, November 16th.
It's the weekend right before Turkey weekend.
Before Thanksmas.
Thanksmas. Yes, Thanksmas. That was actually going to be tonight's title.
That's funny because I celebrate Thanksmas.
That's where I heard about it. I heard it at your wife's party last weekend, Megan. She turned the dirty 30.
The dirty 30, y'all.
And I met a couple of her family members, and we're chit-chatting, stuff like that. And then he mentioned, like, oh, yeah, all the kids go down to California, and then they do this Thanksmas. I'll let you actually explain it better in depth than I am. But then I was like, Thanksmas. I was like, I like that. So right. I was like, I want to call this episode that, but we'll get into why the episode
Dude,
is
named
don't
be trying to
this.
Steal my stuff, man.
I'm not trying to steal your stuff. Dude, I'm incorporating it.
I love it.
Because I go, that's awesome. I've never heard that before, and I like it. I always put, like, Matthew trademark on stuff.
So MTM.
Yeah.
Hey, this is episode 258.
258.
258 on November 16th.
Oh,
so.
Man. I can't. Now I just want us to get to 350.
Yeah.
Oh, I think this episode 350. Yeah.
About 350.
Sitting need about 350. I was like, God damn you, Loch Ness Monster. Yeah. Why you keep coming around here? I gave him a dollar. She gave him a dollar. No wonder he keeps coming back.
Yo, y'all just see up my hump out there in the Loch Ness lake over there.
Classic South Park.
Ah, South Park.
They've been doing good this season.
I know. I'm a little behind, but I've been enjoying it. Well.
But yes.
We would like to tell you where you can hear this podcast. First off, you can go to Spreaker, iTunes, Stitcher, Zune Marketplace, BlackBerry Podcast Directory, the Blueberry Podcast Directory. Have you ever heard of Miro Guide?
I have.
Because we're on there.
Oh.
We got the poddirectory.com. Double Twist. That's twice the twist.
Twice.
Swell Radio, player.fm. Can't find it on the airwaves in your car, folks. You got to go online.
You got to go online.
And now we are on Google Play Music. Oh, wait. You want more Google? We're on the podcast app as well.
I guess you could say you could Google that.
Oh! Hey, do you listen to music on your phone?
I do!
You probably use Spotify.
I do!
Well, even if you use the free version or the premium, you can find us on Spotify.
What?
And we're on Podchaser.
Whatever that is.
Touch my hand. That was fun. We're also brought to you by Revenge Lover. Go to RevengeLover.com and stand out from the rest of the crowd. For samples and inquiries, reach out to our girl, Raven. Mention you heard it on the Four-Eyed Radio Network. I loved to receive 10% off your order.
10%!
She's been doing some killer designs lately,
she
too,
has.
Man.
She did one for the Sabrina.
Yeah,
like,
you were super pumped about it.
Okay, so... I'm happy because I caught up on all those shows like the my Riverdale and stuff. And
yeah.
Riverdale this season. Oh, God.
Season two or three?
Three
oh,
right now is going
shit.
On.
Jeez,
this
man.
Season. But Sabrina, a lot of people like, I love Riverdale. So Sabrina, I was like, boom, jumped into that. Yeah. Like, check it out. I was like, damn. And I've never seen the one with Melissa Joan Hart.
Yeah, neither have I.
I've never seen that.
But beloved by many.
Oh, yeah. But I really like this. Like, if they're going down, like, with the Riverdale and stuff like that, like, this is, like, I was, like, done.
It's the same dude that did Riverdale, right? He's producer, writer, or something?
Yeah. Berlanti? I'm trying to remember. Because he does all that, all the DCW stuff like that. So he's, like...
He knows what's going on.
Yeah, he's basically, like, the Kevin Feige... Kevin Feige of... I was all on Kevin Feige.
Nope.
Nope. He's like that guy for like the DC, but only in TV, which I'm also kind of, but James Wan with that Aquaman, I think they're going to be all like, oh yeah, can you be the Whedon?
I'm telling you, man, I'm super pumped for
Aquaman.
Yeah. It just looks really cool.
Yeah. Did you see, they released those single posters. Did you see those?
I have not seen the posters. I did see the newest trailer that came out and it was cool.
Yeah. They have like the one with Black Manta. I was like, oh, they're going to have him with his helmet off. No, they're like sticking they got with it that. Like, yeah. It's like, I'm sure it's going to be off at one point, but mm-hmm. I think the entire movie, he might just be having it on. I'm like, that's not only ballsy, but it's like, yeah, finally, that's what we want. We hate it when like Batman's like, I'm Ben Affleck. We're like, we don't care.
Oh, it's Ben Affleck.
Who cares? You're going to punch someone in the face? No. So be Batman.
Can you imagine if you didn't know? You had no idea when he took the mask off. You're like, oh, man, I hate Ben Affleck.
Yeah.
You know?
Like, they're just like, this new person's playing Batman. That's what they should have done. Yeah. And then at the
like,
very
who
end,
is it?
And then at the end of the movie, it's like when he's finally like, Alfred, get me. And everyone's like, oh!
This movie fucking sucks.
They do that with, like, Iron Man. They're like, oh, Iron Man is really good. You don't see him until the end.
And he killed it in Phantoms, though.
Yeah.
Actually, he killed
you
him in
Gone
Girl,
too. You were the motherfucking Phantoms.
Yeah.
Exactly. Yes.
Oh, that's great.
Put that shit in my hand.
Wait. $15, little man. Put that shit in my hand. If that money doesn't show that you owe me, oh, we owe. My jungle love. Oh, we owe, we owe. I think I'm going to make it. Or something like that.
Yeah.
Kind of got it.
Who the fuck was that? Who the fuck is Mars Days in the motherfucking time?
Oh, hell yeah.
I fucking love that movie.
I haven't seen that in so long. I'm gonna have to.
I know.
I own it, so I gotta bust it out. But I own a DVD. I'm kind of a Blu-ray guy now. I think I've told you when
honestly, I kind of like it. I might trigger. It will only work with those movies in the era, though. But 90 flicks, toss that in. It takes you back to almost like a VHS.
Yeah.
You're kind of like, oh, because I watch Clerks.
Even on like a, even on a big TV?
Yeah, I watched it. I watched Clerks. Like, I rewatched Clerks, like, not too long ago, because Anna's never seen any of the Kevin Smith stuff.
Yeah.
And she's been listening to some of the podcasts.
Clerks
so
was, it was
yeah.
decent.
Yeah, Clerks
like,
was fun.
This looks
so,
like shit.
No, man, I was just, like, nostalgia, because I'm all like, all I right. remember when I first saw
I like
this
that.
Was VHS, popped it in my VCR, rented it from the video store, and I'm like, this is a fucking great movie.
Hey, man, if there's anybody that loves nostalgia, it's going to be you and I.
Yeah. So that's what I'm saying. Like, but it only works for that 90s era, because once you get to, like, the two, you're like, ah, fuck, should have gotten this on Blu-ray.
Dude, hate to bring it up, people out there, but I haven't watched Goofy movies since you got it for me for my birthday.
Ooh, see, that, yeah.
See, and I've been, like, itching to, especially because, like, Owen's really into cartoons, mm-hmm. like, and I just want to throw it on. We were eating at Los Taquitos or something like
Los
that.
Los Taquitos?
It's, like, over off of the 101 in Ray.
Okay.
It's a, you know, taco shop.
Yeah.
So we were there on a Tuesday one time, and we're sitting outside because the weather was beautiful. And we threw on a phone and, like, was just going, you know, Baby Shark.
Yeah.
All that stuff. And then I was like, oh, let's check out Goofy Movie. So I threw on Stand Out when he's at the assembly.
Yeah.
And he was, like, watching it, but there was, like, background noise. I was like, you're not getting the full effect. I was, like, he's like 18 months. And I'm like, trying to reason, like, you're not really into it right now because you're not in the environment to do it.
Yeah, this is like, there's so much other background. I get it. You're a baby. You're focused on other stuff.
You're like, I want you to love this so much.
I'm always, that's what I'm worried about. I would be so worried if, like, my kid's like, yeah, Dad, all those cartoon shows you used to watch when you grew up, I fucking hate them.
Dude.
And then I'm just all like, yeah, I do want a gun now.
I'm not gonna lie. I'm a little worried about it too, because like music and all that mm-hmm. stuff, and I want him to just be like, oh yeah, like throw on X, you know, whatever, say whatever band here, and it's like, yes. But then what if he's like, I'm into you know, you guys used to listen to dubstep, but now I'm into flurb, and it's like. I just can't listen to that.
Everything's going
to
become a Rick and Morty thing. It's like, yeah, I'm into flurb now. Oh, shit. I don't even know what that is.
He's like,
you're like, how do I spell? You're trying to Google it. You're like,
like, what if it goes the opposite?
Sure. So there was a lot of, get to see the, shit, I'm trying to
remember. You know, I was like, maybe he'd do better than me.
I was like, fuck. And
you're
I'm
super into like
I'm,
the geisha music right now.
Fuck,
you know,
that's the word I was looking for. I'm all like, I was like, Shogun? Like, that's not it.
Shogun would be a lot of like timpani. Like,
yeah, it's just, you know, pretty mild. Yeah.
It's just like, it just really soothes me.
Yeah.
It's not that I have that like conqueror mentality, but it just really speaks to me.
I would say if there's a wall in my way, I probably won't get through it, you know?
I mean, but I'm also really taking on the 80s direction of the Kool-Aid Man. So I feel like maybe I could make it through, especially if the plaster in the drywall is old. Because, like, you're like 80 now.
Yeah.
So your house has to be at least 100, right?
So I could, like, totally, oh, yeah, my way in, you know?
Oh, yeah, dude.
Oh, yeah.
Let's throw in some Flip Flirt.
I like Bjork.
Good to see you, man.
Good to see you, too. How you been?
Good. I've been good. Life.
I know. Life, it comes hard and comes fast.
It comes hard and it comes fast.
This is what my dad told me.
It's, well, the man knows some stuff.
He does. He had four kids, so
hey.
He knows not to use a condom.
Didn't quite master the pull-out method.
Yeah. He's kept saying it was a myth. I seem to be doing really good on it.
I'm not saying I'm an expert, but I know a thing or two about it.
Yeah. I don't always pull out, but when I do, I make sure it's fucking quick. Kind of like, I don't even go for the, oh no, I'm still good. Once it flip, I'm out.
And then? I'm asleep.
In the sheets of shame.
I don't even clean up.
I
lay in my own filth.
I'm disgusting. yeah, we're not going to use this for the Dos Equis ad. What the
fuck
was that? Oh.
This was commercial. I thought this was confessional.
Oh, shit. No, it's all right. You can do what you need. And...
Oh, my gosh. Oh,
what does he sound like?
Yeah. Cheers, man.
Cheers.
That's silly.
Oh, I have like three drinks and I don't know which one to cheer with. Well, I have a beer that I haven't opened yet. I have my mixed drink.
You got your LaCroix in.
My little tangerine.
Tangerine LaCroix.
And this peach blossom vodka.
Peach blossom vodka? Who's that by?
Would have to look at it. I think it's actually by this actual Russian vodka company that I actually like their normal vodka. But these were at, I was at Safeway, and this guy's like, hey, you want to try some? And I'm like, free booze? Yeah.
You said it like
and,
that?
Yeah. Hey, no.
Hey, kid.
I always think, like, I miss that. There's back in the day where you see this cartoon show, it was like, step right up, would you like to try this? We don't get that anymore. Now it's just like, hey. It's like this, and it sucks because you can see them from a mile away, and you're like, all right, I need to get there, yeah. But how do I do it without, it's like Metal Gear Solid. You're trying to sneak around. To get to your
library. Hey, does anybody have a cardboard box that I could borrow?
And then he looks at you, it's all like, bling, bam, 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 bam. Then you
talk.
And then you hear, snake, snake, snake. And you're like, fuck, if I just went to Costco, I would have had the boxes for free.
Oh, yeah.
Market placement.
Not a sponsor.
Yeah. Da 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 da. We're getting sued.
Yeah. Even though we're getting sued, they're like, just tack it on.
Just tack it on. I don't care.
Make room. Keep on going.
Keep on going.
Make tonight, baby. Yeah. Just.
Yeah. You want to keep paying this until you're dead? Yeah.
What if we really dig the cease and desist? I'd be like, okay.
I would. Actually, that's my goal. Once I start the Rick and Morty podcast, I'm really hoping I get a cease and desist because I'm going to frame that shit.
Well, that would be an achievement.
Yeah. You don't shoot high, Matthew. You just shoot to achieve.
Yeah, but I like having that arc in there, you know, a little three-pointer.
Yeah, we'll see. Well, at least I'm going to still do 70 episodes. It might just be airing under different names like Dicking Around and Wienerville. No.
Oh, my gosh.
Anyway, so.
I've been good, man. Just been busy. We went to Strung Out. Did we talk about that last time I was on?
I talked about it last week's show, but it wasn't. It's people were like, I was like talking to myself about it. So yeah, let's talk about this. Yeah. So
yes, I went to a little band called Strung Out. Fat Records, classic band, and I would say in our world.
Oh yeah, definitely. The album came out when we were 14.
Oh yeah,
if I'm not mistaken.
20 years.
Yeah, 20 years. They were playing Twisted by Design.
Hell yeah.
And yeah, and we were going to the Nile.
The Nile. So that was a total throwback for us.
It was like nostalgia, like all down the line.
I will say the Nile. I mean. It's like really cleaned up, you know, from when we were going to shows. It's definitely like they finally sell beer now, which was cool.
That was cool.
You get to enter
through the front.
Yes. Not the alleyway.
Not the alleyway. But I understand why they did the alleyway in the beginning, because you'd walk in and there's the stage.
Yeah.
Because when we came in from the front this time, you kind of walked past the stage. But I actually didn't have a problem with that. I kind of
liked
that.
I thought it was kind of cool.
So the last time I was there, I think it was 5 years ago when I saw Less Than Jake with Matt Hines and Jen Hines.
For sure.
It was a while.
I would say mine was probably 5 years too, 5 or 6 years, because I saw Face to Face.
That's right. Yeah. I was wondering, because I'm like, you were probably not that long ago. But yeah, so it was good. We went to, I always forget the name of the place because I only.
Desert Eagle?
Desert Eagle.
It's Desert Eagle, downtown Mesa,
yeah, downtown
Main
Mesa.
Street.
And I only go there anytime I go to the Nile. So it's like, I can't retain.
Sure.
And honestly, luckily I'm going with people because I don't even know where it is.
The Nile?
No, I know where the Nile is.
Desert Eagle.
Desert Eagle. Like, I've always walked with people, but I wasn't paying attention. But then again, the evening was good for me.
Yeah. That's right. Yeah, so we went over there. I think we had like three drinks there. Shout out to them. They got great stuff.
Yeah.
And
I did a sour. That was
you
really
did the
good.
Sour, yeah.
I did a sour. I did a Pilsner.
And you had the IPA.
And then the IPA.
Yeah, I was rocking the IPA. Then we walked over to Denial. And yeah, it was cool going through the coffee shop, walking in.
I like how we gave it to the man. That was fun.
Oh yeah, yeah.
That's like my favorite story. Like, and I'm like telling it how I was, because in my head I'm all like, I was really centered at that point.
Yeah.
And three beers deep, and on a diet. So.
Oh yeah, yeah.
So I can remember that part.
Yeah, so we got in there and we watched the Bomb Pops.
Bomb Pops, which I got to find them on Spotify.
Yeah, they tore it up.
They tore it up.
Female fronted, and she killed it. They were really cool.
They really enjoyed it. Yeah, we liked them.
And then, Strung Out came on and played Twisted, and then they had an encore and played like 3 or 4 more songs.
What?
And Steve doesn't remember. That's the best.
Oh, my God. So I got blacked out drunk. And all I remember was, I remember Bomb Pops, and I'm like, this is cool, and I was like that. And then I remember you were like, oh, is there any way we can go outside to smoke or whatnot? And I'm like, oh, yeah, which I wish we would have found out a way to do that, because like, I'm pretty sure if I hit my vape stuff, it would have got some nicotine in me. Probably would have like
kind of
chalked me back into like, okay, I'm good now, like kind of thing. But no. So, but yeah, they come on, and the first song hits. I'm like, yeah, this album, because I just listened to the album today. I'm like, awesome, and stuff like that. And then a few other songs, and then kind of blinked my eye, and then a new song. I was like, oh, they're already on this track? Holy shit. And then I remember blinking again, and then all of a sudden, like, my beer was empty, and I'm like, oh, that's good.
Yeah.
And then it was all like, all right, thank you guys for coming out tonight, and stuff like that. And we're like, oh it's done. Okay, cool. And I look at my watch, I'm like, oh, shit. It is done. And we're walking. I'm like, oh, I'm glad Matthew drove. And then I remember being in the car, getting there. And then I was like, I don't know if anybody can understand anything that I was saying. And then I remember having a water bottle, and then I made it disappear. And then I was like, I don't know where the water bottle is. And then driving home.
Yeah.
That was fun. Just straight line home.
Yeah.
So that was good. And then, waking up and then going, I'm still drunk. Oh, fuck. So
you did not go to work the next day.
I took a mental health day.
Yeah.
and then went to bed and woke up at 10:30. I was only going to have a half day at work anyways because I was using vacation time. So to be fair, I woke up at 10 anyways when I would have left work. So I'm like, all right, and perfectly fine.
Yeah.
That was great. I was like, all right. The only thing I had to do is like, oh, shit, I got to pick up shit at work.
Oh, yeah, that's right. So I was like, that's right.
I was like Mission Impossible for me.
Oh, yeah, because I met you at Chiba Hut.
Yeah, then we went to Chiba Hut and you filled me in on what happened. Yeah. Because you're like, no, they play the entire set.
And like, I was like getting sick or something. Remember, I kept on like having to blow my nose and all that stuff. Yeah. Yeah. So we did that. That was fun.
That was fun.
And then
then Red Dead came out.
Red Dead, yep. We've been rocking that. We've been
rocking that.
And then we you guys came over for the birthday.
Yeah, then that was fun.
Yeah, that was great. It was a great night. Megan had her 30th birthday, and it was quinceañera themed.
I think the thing I really enjoyed was the robot rap battles.
Oh, yeah. So you guys were playing Jackbox Party Pack 5.
Which I always say I need to get them, and then I don't get them because I'm like, oh, we never have people over.
They're so, always like a hit.
No, I know. There's a bunch of people playing the game. Yeah, so I was like, yeah, I'll try this time and everything like that. And then, like, we didn't know how the game works, so we're all like, it's like you see the first once, and everyone's like, oh, okay, now I'm supposed to write like a sentence. Uh-huh. Okay. So then you go to do that, and then it's like, oh, it's too much. And then I try to back out, and it's like, time. And then it's like, my thing didn't, I was like, all right, this doesn't make any sense. But then what I love is we all kept voting for this one. We're like, this one's kicking, like, whoever this is. And then finally, it's like the final round. We're like, wait, who is like Nana or whatever the heck it was? And everyone's all like, or Devin or something like that. And everyone's all like, I'm not, nope. It was the computer. The computer beat us. And we're like, are you serious? Like, it was like, oh, man. Because, like, people were throwing down some good ones. You're like, this is really good. But then the next one would come up. You're like, oh, shit, this one got you beat. Devin knows what he's doing. And then everyone's like, who's Devin? Like,
well, now that you guys know, the plan is to beat Devin.
Mm-hmm.
Watch him change his name every time.
Oh, that motherfucker.
Shit, that's that Wiley. That Wiley motherfucker.
Yeah, that Wiley twisted.
That was a fun night. We catered some bros.
That was good.
That was
I did a little bit good. Of a cheat, but it was good.
Hey, we had a lot of drinks. Margaritas, a lot of beer, wine.
Those weird Apple
buzz bomb
buzz bombs, buzz bomb,
buzz bomb.
You know they're gonna be a sponsor like in a week from now. Eric's like, if you guys tried, I don't know why it sounds like that, but if you guys tried buzz bombs, like, look, I love.
Do you think he would like that?
No.
Yeah,
I don't think he would like anything that's sugary. I think he's past sugary stuff. Like at that, like, I mean, he'll eat candy and probably stuff like that because who the fuck doesn't love candy? Mm. But it's like that kind of sugar. Because I'm like even kind of like. I can have a little bit of it, but I'm like, no thanks. Like someone's like, I got a Mike's Hard Lemonade. I'm like, you can shove that back up your ass.
I got a Mike's Hard Lemonade. Good for you.
Yeah.
I don't want that.
I got a
Mike's, don't come near me with that.
I got a Mike's Hard Dick. Hey, what did I tell you? Stop grabbing on my icy dick. Be cool about this. Be cool.
Be cool with my icy dick. Be cool.
Be cool about this. All right. Be cool about this.
Oh, that's funny.
So many double entendres.
Oh, be cool. Be cool, bro. Be cool.
Yeah, be cool, Mike. Come on.
Be hip to your school now.
You're getting kind of loose now.
Oh, my gosh.
Should I call you Mike Loose Lemonade?
See,
where are you peeing?
We had a couple of pinatas.
Yes. I love how... Okay, so the first bat, was that plastic, like a wiffle ball bat?
Yes.
Okay. So, like, you go to... Because you're thinking, I bought this thing.
Hey, were people blindfolded at the first go-round?
No.
Yeah, so that was a major, like, flaw that we...
I couldn't even see, and I was like... Oh. Because, like, people, I was sitting. I didn't want to get up. I was like, oh, good. I've seen them all.
I was comfortable.
I've played Viva Pinata, whatever. Or Piva. What the? I don't even know that
it's
game.
Viva.
Oh, it is Viva.
Yeah, Viva.
Viva. Oh, it's like Viva Las Vegas.
Viva Pinatas. Viva Pinatas.
Is that the theme song to that?
It's not. Oh. Good game, though.
I have every single version of it and never played it. Because it's all like, free! And I'm like, yeah! And I'm all like, I should dive into that.
You're not going to. But it's a good game.
Yeah.
So the pinatas got whacked, had candy all over the yard. The dog was like super like, so that was the thing. But it was good. Good night.
Yeah, it was fun.
Good group of people, family, friends. It was cool. And then, yeah, so I don't know, been pretty good.
Yeah, that was Saturday, and then did you do anything Sunday, just kind of relaxed, chilled?
Sunday, yeah, we just, yeah, Sunday was like just chill day.
So then today it was interesting because you sent us a picture.
Yeah.
Saying like, and then you were like, oh yeah, we did this thing for like Thanksgiving, had games, and I'm like, that is so awesome. Like, I've never heard of, like, quote-unquote, I mean, other than the turkey trot, you know, when you're in elementary school and stuff like that, but, like, a Thanksgiving, like, event to have, like, games and stuff like that, because usually, like, we're probably doing a potluck. Like, everyone does a potluck.
And that's it's like, that's, like, what we did, and this is the first time they did games.
Ooh, okay.
Dude, I am competitive as fuck.
You know.
Competitive as fuck.
Actually,
you
play Mario Kart, you're good. In second, but...
You know, it's really funny because friends of the show... Judy and Josue, but Judy, I work with Judy.
Oh, okay.
So Judy knows me outside of work. And, you know, we've had events where we play games. And so she gets to see the real side of me and not the work side. But today, when we had games, the real side came out.
Oh, shit.
And so we had the potluck and we're all in the main conference room, like eating and stuff. And Hannah comes in. She's like, all right, we're going to start getting ready for the games. You know, we need teams of six. So just start thinking or whatever. And I'm sitting there. I'm just like, so what's the games? Like, what games are we playing? Yeah. Like, what are we doing?
And then you're like, who do I need?
And she was like, we're doing minute to win it games. And I was like, okay, I don't know what that is.
But I'm going to win.
Yes. So I'm just trying to figure out what kind of games they are. Minute to win it. So obviously I'm assuming that they're minute games, but like... I don't know.
Like,
are
is it trivia? Is it
exactly?
You know, is
exactly.
it like, you know, like the head thing where it's like, guess what I am or whatnot?
Right.
You know, kind of.
So we go outside, we get our teams, and the first game is a person is blindfolded.
Okay.
They have two buckets. One's full of cotton balls and the other one's not. They have to take, with one hand, hold this spoon. And take the cotton balls out and put them in the other cup.
Okay.
You have a minute to do it, and whoever
has the most
gets it wins.
Okay.
My team won.
Nice.
So we're starting out one off. Going, you know, second game, I'm up.
Okay.
I'm like, okay, shit, let's do this. The game is you have two plates. One's got M&Ms on it. The other one doesn't. You have a straw, and you need to get as many M&Ms over to the other plate as you can.
Ah.
I came in last place. Let me...
Ooh,
yes,
okay.
Yes, let me...
No.
I definitely fucked up on this game. And as I was thinking about it later, because naturally I would,
mm-hmm.
about how would I have won,
yeah.
there was no rules about how you could get the M&Ms to the other tray. You can only use one hand, and you had to use your straw. So what I was doing was I was sucking the straw on an M&M and putting it over.
Yeah.
That's too time...
Too time-consuming.
Consuming. What I should have done was taken the straw and just started flicking them onto the other plate, and then I would have crushed it.
Yeah.
But I didn't. So I came in last place. I was like, shit, I need to make up for it.
Yeah.
Third game was you held a tissue box.
Okay.
With one hand, you had to pull out all the tissues, whoever did it fastest won. The thing about this game was, all right, cool. But then we all literally were sitting there, we're like, that's such a waste of tissues. You just wasted all those tissues. Like,
yeah.
So it really was like, oh, what the fuck did we play that game for?
Yeah.
The next game, I was up again.
Okay.
You had to take an Oreo.
Shit.
Put it on your forehead, and you couldn't use any hands. You had to maneuver the Oreo down and get in your mouth.
Oh.
I won this game.
Oh. You've done this before.
No, I have not. But I have a video that I can show you.
Nice.
So I did that. I won. Awesome. So right now, my team is up 2.
Okay.
So we're still winning. Next game was you had a tissue box that was like kind of tied, and there was like feathers and ping pong balls in it, and the person had to like shake their butt to get the ping pong balls out. Did not win that game, but that's okay.
Oh, you were up for that one?
No, I was not.
Okay.
I was not. We had another game where you had to blow up a balloon, and you had these little tiny red Solo Cup shot glasses.
Okay.
And you had to turn them over, blow up the balloon, and whoever got all their cups off the table using the balloon air that you blew into it. One, we didn't win that. What other ones did we win? We had a couple other. We ended up winning, but the last one was, and nobody else on the team wanted to do it, so I had to step up. There was chiclet gum. Okay. You know those little square gums?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
There was 18 of them in three pans filled with whipped cream. So you had to find them and spit them on a plate, but you had to, like, spit it clean.
Oh.
So I was like, all right, I'm doing it. So I got up there, and the first round I didn't win. I lost by two. I had 14, and the other person had 16. And then it was like round two.
Okay.
And we went in there, and like nobody else wanted to do it because they didn't want to get messy or whatever.
Oh my God.
So I was like, I'm already covered in it. Might as well go again.
Right. Round two.
So I get in there. Boom. I finish with 18.
Nice.
One. My team won. We had like over it. We accumulated the most points. And so that was really cool.
Gryffindor wins.
And I was super pumped about it because I get very competitive and I was cool. It was cool that like we had won.
That's good. That's fun. I like that. I think more companies should do games for Thanksgiving.
It was funny though because Judy was like, you can't play. Like when I walked out, she was like, no. Because she knows how
I feel. Yeah, yeah.
And I was like, oh, you're scared. You're scared. I'm going to get in your head. I'm going to get in your head. And she was doing the first game.
Uh-huh.
And I was like, Judy, remember aggravation? Because we had played this game, aggravation. Like, I just got in her head. It was great.
Now, have you ever gotten to, like what you were saying, like you get in someone's head. Have you ever, like, someone's like, no, you can't play because blah, 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 and da-da-da. And you're like, no, whatever. And then does it, like, trip you up anytime you, like, you're like, oh, I got this or whatnot, and then you're like, fuck.
Well, the first game, not only did I not play it correctly,
uh-huh.
but, I mean, I was like, I was so like, I got to fucking win. I just get competitive that, like, when I was doing it, like, I was holding the straw, but, like, I was kind of, like, shaking just because of, like, adrenaline, basically. Yeah. And I'm like, oh, shit. And then after I did that, like, I calmed down. It was just like.
You're like, whatever. Okay, wait. Like, yeah. That's funny. I don't know if I've ever been competitive.
Oh, I don't know what it is, man. I just
No. Like, that's what I'm saying. Like, I know a lot. Like me, I should be somebody who does get competitive, but I'm
Smash Bros, dude.
I don't get competitive on that one.
You just are natural. I'm just natural. I don't get competitive. I just win.
I can't help it. Oh, you want
to? That's awesome.
I feel bad because like I'm like, who wants to play Smash Bros? It was like everyone else can play but you, and I'm like, oh, okay.
By myself.
Sometimes it's not the best to be the best at because then people do not want to play with you.
I want to be the very best that no one ever was. Bum, 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 bum. But then I destroyed everyone in Mario Kart, dun, Mario Party, dun, 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 and Mario Bum, bum. I have no friends.
But when you go into it, it's just like Mario Kart, part Mario Party. Just a standard, like, dub over voice.
It's not singing. It's just like, this is the list of my regrets. Holy crap, did he almost win? We came really close. But then he said, you motherfucker, I would have won if you didn't use that ghost. Mario Kart.
How are you, man? How you
been? I'm good. Last week, or this week, I should say, just been like, fuck you, you know?
Dude, it's been a fuck you week for sure, dude.
It's been really weird. So work, I've just been like, not feeling it.
Yeah.
And then.
Do you think it's because Thanksgiving's coming up and it's like, you have senioritis, you already checked out?
No, I don't know if it's anything like that because I like the holiday season stuff because I'm like, actually, it's funny. I was talking
about. No, I love it too. I'm just mean.
Like work wise or just like, you know.
Since you know you have a holiday coming up, you're like,
whatever. No, because I'd rather be productive this week and be like, make the week go by faster.
Look at you. Okay.
You know, be like, all right, I'm like, we all got to do it. Just fucking go through. Because then I'm like, as soon as I get done with work, I can go home. And guess what you can do? Play some Red Dead or play some of this. I tried that Super Lucky Fox. We'll get into that. Not a fan.
Well, we'll get into that.
Sorry. I just forgot that I jumped in. No,
I get it, dude. We'll get into it.
Yeah. Anyway, yeah, we'll have our gaming talk.
Gaming time.
But yeah, so I was just trying to get through this week, and we even had like a half day on Wednesday. We went to main event.
Oh yeah, that's right. Yeah,
like all the stuff, and I wasn't even excited
Wait,
about that.
It was main event.
Yeah, that's where we went.
Oh, that's right. You told me because I was going to write back. I thought in my head, I was like, "Oh shit, he's probably going to play that new Halo game." Because I was thinking,
no, I would have loved to play the game arcades.
Dave and Buster's.
Oh, Dave and Buster's has the
that's
Halo
what,
game.
That's yeah. That's what. Oh, I thought.
Okay. No, they had this cool Ghostbusters game. I would have loved to play games, but no, I got suckered into doing bowling.
What's wrong with bowling?
If I had a choice between gaming for free and bowling, I'm going to go with gaming.
What about laser tag?
They didn't have a laser tag option. It was only bowling. I would have gone with laser tag. They had bowling for our company or gaming. Like
bowling or gaming? Okay.
Like, you know, I'm like, all right, whatever. It was a social appreciation thing. That's what they do. Like, last 2 years, it was at a park, and I was actually okay with the park.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Like, we do those little, like, things. So I'm like, so this year, everyone's like, we're done with the park. Where you want? Like, everyone's been changing stuff. Okay.
I mean, it's kind of cool that they went to main event.
It's
in a
cool.
Way. I mean, it's different.
No, it is different and some of that, but I'll say this. So everyone was bitching and complaining about Rustler's Roost for our Christmas party. Everyone's been bitching and complaining about that.
Okay.
So this year, you know where we're going? We're going to Phoenix Zoo.
Yes, dude.
And me, I'm like, yeah, I'm not a fan, so...
Oh, okay.
I'm like, I've done that, the Phoenix Zoo.
That makes me super pumped.
You know?
But you guys can drink at that one, right?
Nope.
Oh.
We have to wait. Once we're done with work, then you can drink. That's the rule. So it's like no point. It's like I'll put it this way. I've done Zoo Lights, and that was fun. And I've done the Phoenix Zoo, and that was fun. Right now, at my age, the Phoenix Zoo is not interesting to me right now. But if I had a child, if I had a little kid and stuff like that, I'm sure I'd be like, yeah, I want to show them the animals and stuff like that or check out things. Going to do the Phoenix Zoo my age does not look good unless you have a child with you or an elderly person, okay?
I disagree.
It's weird.
I disagree. And here's the thing. I mean, I love that shit.
I know you love that shit.
I love it. So for me to hear that, I'm like, oh, fuck yeah, I'd be totally down with that. I'd be like, shit, I'm going to spend the afternoon at the zoo.
Yeah.
I can understand it. I respect your side of it. That might be a little bit of a drag.
Like, it'd be weird because it's like, all right.
The fact that you can have booze there, because they sell booze there.
No,
now.
They do. Yeah, that's what made Zoo. I've never been to Zoo Lights, and then they're like, oh, you want some Fireball in your coffee? And yeah. I'm like, yeah, whatever.
I mean, Zoo Lights is kind of, although they have gotten some new lights and stuff, but
I've only been there. Okay, never went there growing up.
Okay.
The last time the first time I went, the only time I went was the time when I was leaving, and I'm like, oh, what the fuck? Stay Puft Marshmallow Man's here? What the hell happened?
Oh, yeah.
But yeah, they had like some moving ones. So I never saw, like, I remember always seeing the advertisement, like, Zoo Lights. Mm-hmm. And I was like, Mom, Dad. And they're like, we're poor. And I'm like, oh, yeah. reality set it.
Yeah, it's not bad. But okay. All right. So,
but yeah,
I mean,
so,
they listened,
so,
they changed
it up. Yeah, they changed it up, and I'm fine. To me, I'm like, all right, not my ideal spot. But I'm like, I'll go. It's be fun. But it only sucks because I don't think we can walk around the park until after you're done with your shift. Like, you have the rest of it. And I'm all like, okay. Well, that's kind of weird. So, but I'm just like,
wait, so you guys have like this designated area that you have to like kick it with? You can't go out and explore?
I don't know. Like,
okay.
So, I guess we'll find out in the coming weeks, hopefully. Yeah, unless they're just like, welcome to Jurassic Park. That would be fucking cool, though. I'd be a lot like...
Oh, they have the Big Bug Museum exhibit right now.
Oh, do they?
Yeah, so you can go and see, like, they had the dinosaur one not too long ago where they're like, there's these really big, like, animatronic ones, and right now it's Big Bugs.
Big Bugs. Do I even like bugs?
I mean, there's
some bugs. I kill a lot of them.
I mean, there's some bugs that are...
I kill all the ones that are supposed to help us.
Yeah.
I'm like, hey, Whipping Scorpion. He's like, what's up? And I'm like, ah, fuck.
No, I'm cool. I don't fuck with you. I fuck with the other ones.
Yeah.
Dude, I'm on your side.
You look creepy.
You just stole the words right from mouth. You look creepy.
He comes up. God's like, yeah, I'm really sorry about this.
Yeah.
He's
up there too. He's like, dude. He's like, we cool? We cool.
The bug's like, no. You made me creepy looking. I don't hurt anybody. Yeah. I actually protect people.
He's like,
I always die.
He's like, you did me a favor, man. It's way more chill up here, bro. It's like... It's super chill. They got floor flipped up here, dude.
Yeah, man. It's relaxing.
Am I in the air or am I underwater? Am I in the air or am I underwater?
That was Flurp Flurp with their hit, Am I in the Air or Am I in the Water? So join us next week when we talk all new on Dicking Around.
That's fun.
This is fun.
Hey, I'm going to play a song, and I'm going to go grab a drink or two.
Okay, do you want to take a short musical break?
Or? Actually, I just want to do like a quick, like I'm going to run and grab it, like one song break.
Oh, go for it.
Yeah, man. So like,
hit me with your, oh, that actually leads into stuff. Go ahead, yeah. I have a story after this. genius. So it's just like, this is so good.
Nice.
Yeah, you'd get a kick out of it.
I'll check it out for sure.
Especially if you get really centered.
Really? Really, really? Revenge Lover Designs Illustrate. 10% off, Fern.
I didn't tell everybody I got a new job. I'm going to be doing a Monster Truck.
Monster Jam. This weekend at
the Phoenix Pavilion.
Nice. Or Chase Field.
Yeah.
Talking Stick Resort. Sword.
Maybe in the parking lot.
Dude, Royal Rumble's at Chase Field this year.
Is it?
Or next year, 2019.
Next year. Oh, all right. You got your tickets already?
I don't. I need to get them, dude.
You do?
I do. Royal Rumble.
Fuck, man.
Fucking pumped.
Okay, so I saw that. I actually want to see that movie.
What? Oh, yeah. Oh, for sure, dude.
I was all like, oh, shit, because it looked like, was it Nick Frost?
Yeah, Nick Frost in there.
He plays the dad. Of course, like, there's
Dwayne. Steven Martin? No, I'm not saying that correctly.
I'm trying to remember. It was like The Family We Fight With.
Yes. It's based off Paige.
Oh, it is. Okay. I was all like, oh, I was like watching. I was like, this looks really good. I'm going to send it over to Matthew. I think this is related to stuff he's into.
No, dude, that was perfect. The Rock, he's like producing it.
Yeah, I saw that come up.
Yeah, it looks really good. So definitely go check out the trailer. I think it's going to do great. Mm. I think it's do really, really good, especially with all like the people that are in it.
Yeah, no, it should be fun.
Yes. Yes. Anyways, yeah, Royal Rumble's coming, so that's going to be pretty cool.
So, I'm excited. That's interesting. Have they ever done a wrestling match at Chase Field?
I don't know. That's Royal Rumble's been here before, but I don't know if they've ever done one at Chase Field. So we'll see. But yes, I need to get my tickets.
All right, do that right now.
Before we played the song, you were like, oh, yeah, we're going to segue into we can segue into that after.
Oh, yeah. Speaking of music and everything like that, because I was just talking about main event and stuff like that. So we're outside doing the smokers or whatnot. We're out there and they're playing music. And, of course, I've noticed with our age group now, everything they're playing is like what we grew up in high school and all that kind of stuff. You're like, all right. So a Britney Spears song comes on.
Okay.
And let's see. I think I'm actually going to pull it up so I can give you. I know for a fact you'll guess it right off the bat. So let's see.
Ooh, I'm kind of intrigued by this.
Because it's like early.
Oops, I did it again.
Fuck you.
Toxic.
Yeah, you got it.
It's Oops, I Did Again.
Yeah, this pops like in. Yeah, I'll play a little bit of it to get the. So you're listening to this outside, basically.
Ooh, yeah.
Okay, so this came out in 2000. Yeah.
We're sophomores.
Mm-hmm. Because the other one was. So this starts up and this girl's all like, oh my god, this is like her first song. And I'm sitting there going like, is it?
Mm-hmm.
Oops, I Did It Again.
It is.
I thought it was Baby Hit Me One More Time.
No, this is her first song.
This was her first song, really?
This is the same song, dude.
It is?
Just listen. Wait, no. Hit Me Baby One More Time.
Yeah. Yeah, this is that one where she's in that red spandex suit on the music video.
No, that's Toxic. You know what's really funny, dude? We're sitting here talking about Britney Spears and all these This is definitely her first one.
Is it?
Yeah.
Okay, because this came out in 2000.
This is when she's like in her the schoolgirl dress.
This is the schoolgirl dress?
Yeah. Because
I thought the schoolgirl dress was.
Oh, shit, I'm wrong.
You are?
Megan says I'm wrong. She says Hit Me Baby was her first one. So you're right. Dude, of course you're right, man. It's all like that stupid movie trivia and bullshit. Now you're dipping. Wait, hold up. Now you're dipping into music trivia?
Oh, shit.
All right. Play Hit Me Baby.
Yeah, I got it.
Yeah, for sure. You're right. You're right.
Something wasn't right. Oh, baby, baby. Well, anyways, I thought you'd be proud of me.
Yeah, I am.
Because this girl's saying this shit, and I'm going all like...
You're like, bitch, no.
I was like, no. I know that, because I know the music video for this one. I remember because she does this weird dance move, because Lost in the Game, that always stuck with me, because I'm like, gaming.
And this is when she's in the school.
She's like, no, Baby Hit Me, Hit Me Baby One More Time is her in the school outfit. The Oops, I Did Again, she's in that weird red spandex, like, and everything's like a fucking George Lucas film.
Which one's the toxic one? Is she in the jungle outfit?
That has to be that one, because I've never seen the toxic one. I don't even know what toxic sounds like.
It's probably on there.
No, I guarantee it's on there.
Wow, man. We on a Britney Spears.
I know, we're right now. There we go. So like, you type in toxic, you don't get that song right off the bat.
Yeah, this track.
Okay, so I know this track. I don't know if I've ever seen the music video.
Hey, do you know Not Yet a Girl, Not Yet a Woman? No, I'm just kidding.
No.
I don't know if that's
easy. I think this is where my Britney knowledge stops. Baby, can't you see?
Mark Ronson does a pretty legit cover of this.
Oh, yeah?
Let's see if I can find it. Look at that, man. Britney Spears. We're so, we love music, man. Yo, check this shit. Watch this.
Thing. Ooh. A girl like you should wear a warning. It's dangerous. I'm falling. Oh, nigga, I'm burning up. There's no escape. I can't wait. I need a hit. Baby, give me in. You're dangerous. I'm loving it. Ooh. Shut down the Grammys, ask for Grammy. Who came for the kids, but your host can't stand me. Who came for the kids, plus I'm all the family. Catch me on Disney. Mom, who is he? Down dirty, stinking, grimy, grizzly. Old man McGurk looking under the skirt. Fuck the pussy till his eyes like Ernie and Bert. Like, ooh. Nice little revision of it. Yeah.
I wonder if Britney's still doing like her residency in Vegas.
Last time I was there, which
Last time you looked up tickets.
Yeah, last time I looked up tickets, they're out of my price range.
Was she there when you guys went?
Last two times I've been there, like within the couple of last years, she's been having that residency. So
okay,
she might still be there. I'm not sure who would knock her out unless there's like Celine Dion coming back. She did have that hit with the Deadpool 2 movie. So
she did. Little resurgence right there.
Yeah.
I don't think it ever went away. I mean,
no,
she's just one of those
she's like, hi, I'm here and I'm never going away. And
it's like, what
movie did you do? The boat one?
No, The Bodyguard.
Celine Dion.
My bad.
That's Whitney Houston. Wow, you're all over the place.
You're right, man. What's happening?
Yeah,
right
what's
now?
Going on?
What's happening, dude?
When Matthew and Steve switch, Steve knows everything about music. What?
This is Face Off, dude.
Oh, jeez, it's so weird.
Whoa.
No,
I'm not even sure. Whoa. Wow. No, Owen Wilson.
No, if you want to do it, you do John Travolta, I'll do...
It's so weird.
Yeah.
It's so weird.
It's crazy. I
have all this knowledge of Britney Spears now.
It's like I'm... No.
It's whoa.
It's weird. Why don't we just bottom massage?
Bottom massage.
Jeez. You know how to fly a plane, and I was on Con Air.
I also have a line of luxury watches.
Yeah, and I like to like touch. Sin. I like to touch penises.
I'm like Scientology, baby.
Yeah, I
hold those little knob things.
I hold knobs too. Just some men, you know, alien men who fly.
The way I can read people is.
Oi, and then they turn into Jerry Lewis. I
want to give you guys some readings. So, I gotta get you hard and hold on to your nose.
Whoa, cool hand Luke over here.
Hey man, you guys are really hot right now.
This is a nice ice hold lemonade. How you doing, Mike? And Michelangelo?
I think you guys are gonna do great. I think you guys are gonna do great within the congregation.
Hey, do you guys want a doc? Here we go.
You
guys have a Chinese finger trap?
Oh, there's a third one here. It's me. Hello. I really wanted to segue. I love that we were talking about covers.
Who's this foreign force coming in from the north?
Oh.
Yeah, I like to come from behind. I'm going to make your ass off.
Whoa. Oh, just right. Call me Sandy.
All right, let's segue.
So I was trying to segue because I was like, oh, doing the Toxic with the cover would have been a great way to go into some covers I've heard. But I did want to talk about before we dive into some music or whatnot. But we lost people this week.
We lost a couple.
We lost. Oh shit! I sent it over to you guys in the. I feel really bad.
In the chat.
In the chat, yeah. It was the guy who he voiced Hal in 2002 Space Odyssey. I know, I think it was David. I feel really bad now. I'm looking like a piece of shit.
I'm just going to let you sit in your shit, dude.
You're no fun.
I am tons of fun.
It's so weird, Sandy. I can't find. There's so many posts about Eric's beer.
There's so many beer posts. That's so funny.
He's like, I'm drunk. Look at my dick.
I was trying to.
Fuck! I was way off. I got the D right. Nice. Douglas Rain, voice of Hal in 2000 Space Odyssey. He dies at like 90. So I mean, again, like
good life.
Good life. Big bucket of win and everything like that. I don't know if this is true. I saw it, but I think it was like one of those spoof. Webpage, like one of the people I followed that just like to post shit to rile people. Did someone from Aerosmith die?
Not that I know.
Okay. Because I came up today, I was like, no, that's not right. But no, I didn't bother to actually research it. And then I believe the guy who, you know, wrote, Princess Bride, A Few Good Men, he passed away as well. Actually, I think he died today or even yesterday. And then, of course, one of the biggest hits, which like the beginning of the week, was Stan Lee.
That was a that's a hard one, man. It's a hard one, but like I've been kind of waiting on it.
No,
you know,
yes,
know what I'm saying.
This is what it is. It's one of those things where you know he's up there, and they've already talked about it, like how he's already shot like so many of his cameos, and you're kind of like okay, and then you've seen like him it. You know, in videos and stuff, and he's not who he was, kind of thing. And you kind of sit there going like, okay, but it's like every day you'd wake up and go, oh, the news hasn't dropped, so it's okay. Everything's fine.
It's like Stanley's
gonna, yeah, he's going to live on forever. Like, I was just hoping he would make it to his 100th issue. That would have been awesome.
Yeah.
But fucking God had to cancel him at 95. Piece of shit.
He has left a legacy.
Legacy.
He will live on in infamy. Like... The dude lived a beautiful,
a great, righteous life. And just pure, you know?
Yeah.
Like, everything, like, he gave back to the readers. Like, he always was like, you know, he always said, like, well, why do you do these recaps? You know, he's like, well, everybody, who knows? This could be somebody's first comic book. Instead of them having to go back and track everything, they can kind of get a short summary and then be like, okay. And it could not even be like one of those limited edition issues, but people would be like, this was my first comic book. This is my favorite comic book.
And I came to respect him late in the game. Like, the MCU.
Oh, yeah.
The fact that this all has been developed and centered around this man creating it. Like, I have so much respect for the guy. And so I look at it and I'm like, you can't go anywhere without seeing Marvel.
Mm-hmm.
Like, this is part of life. This is like Disney.
Yeah.
Hence why Disney owns it.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? It's just like he created this mecca and it's beautiful. And the world lost... a mighty powerful person.
Oh, yeah. I mean, just even some of the books he wrote, like X-Men was a whole thing about, you know, the, you know, divide between, you know, the whole, you know, whites and blacks and everything like that and the difference between that. But he was all like, we'll tell it with mutants, you know, and it's, and you sit there going like, oh my God, yeah, it's the same like thing, even writing, you know, stuff for the Black Panther and bringing that, you know, people going, yeah, we can have, you know, like so much inspiring and just everything with him and just everybody who's met him and talked to him and his interviews are great, and he's just, you know, he's always just been happy, you know. Right. And it's just funny because, like, his wife, you know, he was almost about to be like, no, I'm kind of done doing, like, these stupid books. She's like, well, just write a story that you want to write. Just finally write the story that you want to write. And then he ended up writing Fantastic Four. And that was, like, the kickoff of, like, oh, we can do this, superheroes, yeah, you know, kind of thing. So it's just, you know, I know he's inspired me, obviously, like, creativity of just coming up with stuff. And just,
for sure.
You know, and then everybody else who's ever probably drawn, you know, it's just like, oh my God, this is like, you know, he, even though he wrote for things, but created Spider-Man with Steve Ditko, that people like, oh shit, and stuff. And I thought one of the biggest thing was, like, you know, all the tributes that people did, like,
yeah,
all the artwork, yeah, and some of that. Actually, one of my favorite,
really, been really powerful.
It has been. And it was like, it was almost like when, oh shit.
You were going to say one of your favorite ones.
Yeah, one of my favorite ones was, like, it's him walking up, and he's like, oh, Steve. And he finally runs into Steve Ditko, you know, and they're chit-chatting and stuff. And they're just like, oh, I think they're in good hands now. And, you know, with all these, it's just like,
yeah,
just like, you forget about that. Like, you're like, yeah, it sucks that he's gone. But now you're like, well, now he's up there. He's back with his wife.
Right.
He's, you know, with all of his, all, everybody he grew up with. Like, he probably outgrew, like, not outgrew, but, you know, outlived a lot of these people. You know, it's just a sad thing that it's like, you do realize these people who've created kind of pieces of your childhood, and
that's,
you know, they're going to be going away soon, you know.
That's exactly what it is. And you and I, both being 34, we've grown up with these figures, these characters, throughout our entire life. You more so getting into the world of it at a younger age than I did. I didn't follow it. I knew who they were.
Yeah, yeah.
But it's a thing that is ingrained into us. And you're absolutely correct. I mean, we're getting to a point now where our heroes are life with these people is coming to a point where now they're starting to leave us.
Yeah.
And it's hard, man. It's definitely hard, just because it's part of who we are. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I feel like I'm just kind of talking in a circle where it's ingrained in us, and, like, the creators of these things that are so prominent and we in a way worship, their lives are coming to that point.
Yeah.
It's life is crazy, dude.
Well, what I can imagine, like, okay, with my parents, you know, with, like, a lot of their, the people they've, you know, they grew up, their influences, stuff of that, like, a lot of them were, they didn't die of natural causes. A lot of them were ripped from them. You know, when John Lennon, I remember my parents telling me that story when they turn on the radio and wake up and you're like, oh my God, or my mom was like, when, you know, Kennedy was assassinated. Like, a lot of these people, it's like, we never got to see, you know, if Kennedy lived, like, Kennedy wasn't assassinated, like, we'd be like, oh, Kennedy passed away. And we'd be like, oh, who was that? My mom would be like, oh, well, he was this president at this time. And, you know, give you, like,
lived
a story,
his
you know,
lived his life.
You know, lived his life. But a lot of them is now, like, you know, some of them have these, you know, harsh, like, realities of, like, they were killed in their, you know, 30s. And you said they're going like, oh, shit, I've outlived so-and-so, you know, and stuff. But then it's also like, you realize, like, a lot of our people get to live to a certain point. I mean, like, you know, Kevin Smith had that heart attack and everyone was like, oh shit, that's it.
Yeah.
And then it's like, he got his shit together, you know, hopefully we have him, you know, hopefully we have him till he's 95.
So if we're kind of, like, adjusting to a conversation of, like, life and death and that stuff, it's like, yeah, it's a thing that happens. It's natural. In the way that it happens for each individual is different. And it's crazy, the spectrum of what it can be.
Yeah.
I mean, just recently, the Irwins, like Steve Irwin and his family, like, they have this new show. Basically, it's like Crikey with the Irwins. And so his wife and
daughter and son,
Bendy and, I'm blanking on his name right now, which is really sad. Anyways, his kids, they have this new show, just like he did, and education and everything like that. I love that shit, all about it. So I've been starting to watch it, but take him for example.
Exactly.
This guy was like, He was a crocodile hunter.
He was a big influence. In fact,
he was huge. He was so educational. He was so everything. And like, he's really left a legacy. If you watch this stuff, it's like incredible what he's done for conservation. But yes, dude, a fucking stingray took him out. He went out in nature. Like that scene, I don't even want to say it seems fitting for what it is, but like he did what he was loved to do, and nature got him.
Yeah.
And that was so unexpected, especially with like everything that he's built, like this whole thing. I'm only talking that because that's kind of super fresh in my life right now that I'm watching.
Well, you can't watch the Kennedys because that's not on the air.
I mean, you're absolutely right, though, like the spectrum of it. So, like, we haven't experienced a presidential assassination.
No, we haven't. Actually, and been watching, like, I'm almost done with the 70s. I finished 90s and 80s.
Oh, you've been going, nice. Oh,
I went backwards.
Yeah.
But, like, okay, I'm going to put it this way. I don't care who the president is. Like, whether you elected him, whether you're not elected him, and this goes for every single president. Holy fucking shit. Do they have a hard fucking job?
No kidding. Like, yes.
Like,
absolutely.
I was watching, like, okay, didn't even know about this until I watched the 70s. Gerald Ford, someone tried to assassinate him twice.
Yeah.
Twice.
Yeah.
This is the first time I've heard about this. I was like, what? And one of them was from the Manson family that went right up to his face with a gun. And yeah. I was all like, and we give this president shit. Why? Yeah, he was a little slow, maybe, and he fell over a lot, but holy shit, like, all the shit that's left on people's laps after they bounce out of a presidency, like, God bless you, people. Like, seriously, you're literally walking into a place that's like, oh, you've burnt everything to the ground, you've salted the grass, and you've taken shits and peed, not just your own urine, but cat urine, all over this place, and you want me to fix it. Thank you. Like, everybody has to deal with this shit, and I feel bad for them. Like, I mean, I would never want to be president.
Well, I mean, it's a job.
Yeah, it's a crazy shitty job.
But technology and everything has come to the point where it is now. That's granted, true. It's still a huge, huge, huge risk of everything.
Yes,
but it's not like it was back then.
Exactly.
And so, yes, you're right. You go back and you watch all these historical things, and you're like, holy fucking shit! Like. That dude just literally like walked up past everybody and was like, yeah. Yo, what's up, man? Pop. Like, yeah. You know what I mean? It's just crazy.
It's crazy.
It's funny. I saw a video the other day of Reagan giving a speech after he was shot.
Yes.
And he's doing this speech and a balloon pops and he makes the comment, you miss me. But like, you know, it's just like little things like that. And I just came across it and I was like, oh, that's clever, you know.
Oh, he's big in that 80s doc.
Like. But it's like there's got to be like some post traumatic stress that stuff. Like, yeah.
Well, that's with everybody. I mean, like it was sucks because
I think that's really cool that you went back and you watched the other ones. Like,
yeah, because I
they're
started,
super good.
I
man.
Started with the 90s and I was like, this is really cool. And I was like, well, let me check out the 80s. I know a little bit of the 80s, and then when I learned about like all the boom, like the technology boom pocket, and you're just sitting there going like. And, like, stuff that Steve Jobs said. He's like, I hope one day you can all hold this like a book. And you're like, oh, shit.
Well, it lets you know what was happening prior to us when we were here, but too young to realize. And, obviously, when we were, like, able to know what was going on, but at a adolescent level.
Yeah.
So it's like, oh, shit. Like, the world was still a thing. Like...
Oh yeah, the world is scary.
Oh, the world.
I don't care what era you're in. Like, cause like I went back to the 90s. I'm all like, and this is like I must have been at this age. Okay, the Unabomber and the Oklahoma City bomber. I thought it was the same person.
Oh.
And then it was like, no, it was two. And I'm like, we had a lot of bombings in the 90s. Holy fucking! How did we survive? And then I remember our elementary school had a bomb threat. I remember being marched down to the Greenbelt. And then marched to the middle school for safety.
Wow.
Because no one knew what was going on. And then we found out it was a hoax, you know, later on. But it was just like, I remember actually being part of a bomb threat in the 90s. Wow. Yeah.
That's wild.
And I must have been like probably first, second grade.
I don't know about that. Well, first, second grade. Wow.
Yeah that's what I'm saying. Like, it was like elementary school.
That's super
like,
low.
But then I think about it, I'm like, but that's when all those bombings were going on. So, of course, if somebody did not want to be at school that day.
Yeah, they were just.
They were going to call in the bombing. And capital, then you But then you think about it, you're like, well, yeah, there was no such thing as caller ID back then. Yet.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah, straight up.
That's what I'm saying. Like, all this stuff is much easier to get away with. And it's just crazy that you, like, you don't think about it until you, I was watching that going like, oh, that's right. There were a lot of, like, bombings happening in, like, the 90s. Like, as bad as to say, like, we were the bombing era, I guess. But it's like. It's like a weird thing because like now it's like the huge, like with the school shootings, you know, right. going on and stuff. So it's like this weird trend of like, cause like in the I was watching the 70s one and there's just one of just like all the serial killers. And then you're like, oh yeah, that was all in the 70s. Like these big time, you know, serial killers. And you're like, oh shit. Like
Gacy and all that
stuff?
Yeah,
Gacy. I think it was, oh fuck. Who's the, Ted Bundy.
Those were all the 70s.
Yeah. Because I was just got done with all the ones that happened in the 70s. Son of Sam, Zodiac Killer. Like, all that stuff was in the 70s.
Wow. It's I need to watch that one.
You'll get, like, if you, I already know you love the 90s. 80s, definitely check out. You'll be like,
oh I love the 80s.
And then 70, I just started watching just for, like, because I don't know much about
it's only
the
70s. Those three, though, right?
Yeah, I was hoping there was, like, a 60s or even a 2000s.
Maybe it will come through, because is Tom Hanks associated with all of them?
Yeah, so I think the first one might have been the 70s.
Okay, and then go through.
So they might tackle the other ones, but I'm hoping.
You know, even the Clinton shit.
That was interesting.
You know, because I knew about Monica and all that stuff, but then, like, when you really get into it, like, whoa, I didn't realize that he... I knew that he had done a lot for the country.
Yeah, yeah.
I didn't realize how much, and then the blowback.
Yeah.
And then he was able to overcome it, and all this stuff. It was like this... such a prominent thing that was like, whoa, what's going to happen? Like, holy crap, dude, it's like a tennis match. And me being the age that we were, I just know that, like, oh, okay, so, like...
Like, the only thing we
like,
focused on...
something happened was, like, with this lady?
Yeah, he,
like,
cheated on his wife. Like, that's the only thing that I got at that age. Like, was just like, okay, so...
Yeah.
I just got loaded up. That's what happened. That's right. Billy Tricky Dicky's coming out. That's the best part. I've been watching these documentaries. I can do every single fucking president so far during it. It's been fun.
I'm sure you could.
Oh, man. Yeah, but I was good, Matthew. I was good, man. You ever had a blowjob in the oral office, man? I'll tell you what. Next time you go down to Washington, right? You go down there. You go like, oh, yeah, we know. We got to take a piss or something to sneak off, you know? Get yourself a blowy.
We got to piss. Hey, I got to... You gotta take a piss.
Just some old Clinton Billy told you.
Oh my gosh. Anyways, that stuff was just really, really interesting to know the dynamic and like all the players involved and like all this stuff. It's
really interesting. We're just too young, when you see like Pat Buchanan when he does like some of the interviews and stuff, and you're going like, I remember him. Didn't he run for president? Like, it's like this weird thing. But then you realize he's
been... like, even the older reporters, Peter Jennings, and like, all, you know what I mean? It's like, oh, fuck, I remember these people.
Oh,
like,
yeah, fuck yeah.
And then they have a sight out of mind. Like, it's just, when's the last time you...
Well, that was like, like Walter Cronkite. Like, the craziest one is 80s. You start the 80s, it shows, it's like, everyone talks about like, yeah, this is when we said goodbye to Walter Cronkite. This is when he retired, like at some point. And then you go back to the 70s, and he's like the prominent, like, you know, aspect. And it's funny because then you see like Tom Brokaw, you know,
and
you see him like a little bit and stuff like that. But then you start like, it's still like people go away. Like then you go, oh, okay, this is when this person started becoming like the popping, you know, like that was the person we got our news from, you know. And it's like, because I think like the 70s opened with like MASH ended. And it talks about that. It's like so.
Which was a huge event.
Which I love doing the first two episodes is always television. I always love watching that because you get to see like I think the 70s talk about like, what was it? All in the Family.
Okay.
Like they were talking about like they ended up, ABC ended up canceling all their shows at one point. Like one network canceled all their shows to bring like good, clean family programming. That's when we got like Little House on the Prairie. And like, and then you're like, okay. Oh, that shit came out in the 70s. Oh my God. Like
my mom loved that show.
Like, I feel bad if I'm spoiling shit, but yeah, definitely check that shit out. I love that stuff.
Hold up. Spoiling things? You want to reevaluate the sentence you just said, my friend?
I'm sorry, Matthew, but I had a time machine, and I found out what it is in the 70s. And I'll tell you this, Little House on the Prairie was huge.
It, dude.
As big as my cock.
Oh, okay. That's
a my lot. Rooster. Get your head out of the gutter.
Oh.
House on the prairie. It's all farmland. Come on. You fucking penis pusher.
Okay, Mr. Passive Aggressive motherfucker.
I will cut you. I have a fear no one will find you.
Whoa.
Little House on the Prairie has been canceled.
Oh, my gosh. That got really dark.
Yeah, it did get dark.
Well, I'm super pumped to watch those other ones.
Yeah,
like,
I love them. I feel bad because I'm going to be done with the 70s soon. I'm going to be like, fuck.
Well, they're ones that are good that you can turn on. And if, like, you're doing things in the background, like, you can still hear it.
Yeah.
And then, like, pipe up and be like, oh, shit, okay, yeah, and, like, see the footage. But it's, like, history, man.
It's crazy, though, because there's one thing in the 90s that I didn't see. And I was kind of like, well, maybe they didn't touch upon it because it wasn't that big in, like, that thing. But to us was everything. Remember the Bit Wars. Super Nintendo going up against Sega Genesis. And everybody was all about, like, well, this one's got 16 bits. This one's got 8 bits. This one's got 32 bits. This one. We had no idea what the fuck anything that was. It was just a system plastered something on itself. Mm-hmm. And we're like, oh, well, it's got more bits. It's got to be better.
With that, I was a Nintendo kid, man. So
I was,
like,
I was everything.
So when the Super Nintendo came out, I was like, yes, that is what I want. Although I did play Sega at my friends' houses, but the Sega was the foreign system to me, man. I didn't have a Genesis.
Yeah.
I didn't have any of that stuff. I didn't have a Master System. I had a Nintendo, and then I was like, Super Nintendo? Yeah, I want to be fucking super. I mean, I always enjoyed Genesis, but it was just foreign to me.
No, it's funny because the first console we got after, like, the, you know, the Television, ColecoVision, and then, like, the Atari, you know, 2600, which wood paneling, fake and shit like that.
Right.
We wanted a Nintendo, but my dad went out and he got the Mega Master System, and we had that for a bit. But this was, like, the only time, like, back in the day where we'd be like, we don't like it, and you had, like, 30 days to return it. So my dad just packed it up. Brought it in, got the Nintendo, brought that home. Then we had the Nintendo pretty much.
Right.
So then when Super Nintendo and Sega Genesis came out, my brothers must have, like, played the Sega Genesis before the Super Nintendo. So they're like, oh, we want the Genesis. So they got that for, like, their birthdays or something like that. And then me, I was like, Genesis is cool, but I like the Super Nintendo. I got a chance to play that. So I ended up getting Nintendo. I bought the Genesis later, like, when they, like, miniaturized it or whatnot.
Right,
and I was like,
right.
Oh, okay. And then I was like, oh, I can respect, like, Sega. But I never got, like, every single one of Sega's system because, like, Saturn I skipped out on.
Did not have a Saturn.
I skipped out on the whole, like, bullshit 32. Like, let's pop everything into
Turbo,
this thing.
Yeah.
I was like, fuck that.
On Game Gear.
Yeah, I skipped on Game Gear, too. Game Boy was just great. And then it lasted longer. That was the thing. So it was always
back in on Dreamcast.
Yeah, I got Dreamcast. Yeah, I was all like, ooh, Sonic's looking pretty slick. And then I was like, oh, shit, look at all these games. Like,
For me, man, I was all Nintendo. I was a loyal like Nintendo customer. NES, Super Nintendo, 64, and then GameCube. Like, I didn't have a Wii U. I've always been Nintendo, man. Genesis, I don't know what it was. I don't know if it was a bit too edgy for me or something. I just wasn't in that world. Like, even with the Genesis, like Sega Genesis,
yeah.
The controller was all, like, kind of sharp and, like, just like, oh, you know, like, I got teeth in my hand right now. And
I was
just like, I'm not feeling that, man. Just give me my fucking X, Y, B, you know, B, A, and my triggers.
Yeah, your ABCs.
Just give me that, man. I just need that. Super FX.
Yeah, I think the only thing that, like, really, like, brought me to Sega was just Sonic. I was just like, I like these games.
Don't get me wrong. I loved when we would go to, like, Target or Sears or something, and they had, like, especially when Jurassic Park came out.
Oh, the Jurassic Park game.
And you could play as a Velociraptor.
Yeah.
I would get down on that. But it wasn't enough to make me, like, oh, I need to have this.
Yeah.
I would just be like, shit. Same with the PlayStation, dude. When the first PlayStation came out and Wipeout.
Yeah.
I would just go to, like, KB Toys and, like, be like, well, fuck it, dude. I'm just going to play Wipeout on the PlayStation.
Okay, so I know I'm going to get this classic PlayStation, but I feel like what they're bringing to the table in this console is kind of weak.
It's super weak.
It's very weak. And I'm going, okay.
I mean, there's a couple of good games.
There's a couple of good games, and I like the nostalgia feeling.
I wonder if it's like a licensing thing.
Well, okay, I understand that. But you're going to charge us $100 for 20 games.
Right.
Two controllers, okay, but you don't give us the power thing. You have the cord to plug the system in with a USB thing, but we have to find our own power source now? What the fuck, Sony?
Can you play discs on it?
I don't know. They have not talked about that. I mean, the system does look big enough to put a disc in, but I don't know if you can actually put memory cards in this thing. I think it's all for show. But this is the thing. Okay, again, everybody, don't get me wrong. I like my PlayStation 4. Do I have a lot of games for it? No, I have a lot of... Well, actually, I do have a lot of games for it because they keep giving me games for their Plus, and I'm just like, yeah, I'll download it. I haven't touched a lot of these games. But a lot of their exclusives, yes, I have. Like, I just finished the expansion, the newest DLC, and another one drops next week for Spider-Man. And don't get me wrong, I love the Spider-Man game. I thought the storyline, main storyline, was great. This DLC thing they're doing kind of right now is a little weak.
Okay.
Wasn't too impressed with this one, this chapter. Next chapter, hopefully a little bit better.
What's next chapter?
Well, basically, spoiler alerts.
That's fine.
Well, I know not for you, but I'm just talking for listeners out there who are playing.
Just kidding. I love them.
So you finish the main story, which is amazing, which is a great written like Spider-Man story, and like perfect done and everything like that.
Cool.
Then you play this one, and so Black Cat comes back.
Right.
So you're like, all right. So you're trying to figure out what she's going on with this. She talks about how Hammerhead, this mob boss, has stolen like her son. You're like, oh shit, is it my kid at this point? Because you're like, oh okay.
They banked.
Builds all this tan. Well, yeah, Peter, I think he's had sex with like three women.
Nice, good for him.
It's good for Peter. Good for Pete. So he has that going through his head of like, oh shit, do I have a son? Do I not have a son? Then you find out it's all a lie that she told you because she was trying to get these like, you know, it's yeah, all out for her own game. It ends with her like about to walk into her penthouse. She kind of looks back at Spider-Man with a smirk, even though he told her like, hey, they've rigged your house with explosives, and the door goes off. Obviously, I know she survived.
Right.
It's Black Cat, blah, blah, blah. But you're kind of like, okay, but for this story, it was kind of like...
So the next DLC continues that?
Yes. And I'm kind of like...
With new people coming in?
Yes.
Okay.
So I'm like, okay, but I'm also kind of like... I was kind of hoping like each one would have been its own...
Own thing. So do you know who the next people coming in are?
Yeah, I already know you're going to be finding Tombstone, which is like, okay. Who knows if Black Cat's going to be in it? They have like some Silver Sable shit coming back into it because that was in the main story and stuff like that. So, we'll see what happens. I mean, Grant, I already bought it, so I'm getting them, you know, anyways, because I bought, like, the 79.
Do you know how many are supposed to come out?
Three. Okay. So, the first one came out in October. Yep. The game was released in September.
Yes.
So, first one came out in October. Second one's coming out next week on Tuesday, the 20th. And then I'm guessing the next one's going to come out in December. So, it's supposed to be part of The Longest Night, is what it's called.
Okay.
So, I'm like, okay, I get what you're doing, but it seemed like... But then I don't know if they're going to turn around and go, we're like Destiny. You think you bought everything, but here's the stuff that you really wanted.
Yeah.
So that's what I'm worried about.
If
that comes out, I don't know if I think I'll probably wait for a Black Friday sale and then purchase some stuff, which I did check out some Xbox stuff already. Witcher's full edition.
Witcher, nice.
$20.
Oh, yeah.
I'm thinking of doing it.
Worth it.
But yeah, it's just this weird, like, I was kind of like, I was like, okay, I enjoyed it, but I'm like, not as good as you. Like, I love the original. So I'm like, all right, let's see how this DLC, you know, kind of plays out. I mean, and they keep giving you new suits, which is like, oh, okay, but like, do I really
need to spend any?
They're suits.
Yeah.
It's like, I mean, yeah, it's cool, but like the one I've been rocking the most is the punk rock one.
You've been doing that
one? Like, that's all I've been doing. Like, I've tried on the other ones. Like, yeah, this is fun and stuff like that, but I was like, I did like the homecoming one. For a bit, and I was like, that's cool. But then they're finally releasing the Iron Spider from the comics, and I'm like, I like that one. They're also releasing like this Iron Spider suit, which was
like from Tony Stark.
Actually the old 90s Spider-Man cartoon.
Okay,
so I was like, oh, that one's kind of cool. Though they have that one, you can wear that one that he wore in Infinity War,
okay,
and then also the Homecoming one. So, like, they have a bunch of stuff, which is like, okay, they also have like his original costume with like the the goggles and stuff like that. I'm like, okay, they also have like a comic book one where it's all cel shaded, which is really cool.
Oh, that's
fun. I mean, they're fun and stuff like that, but it's also like, it doesn't, it's like, okay, I'm just in a new suit. You know, it's basically like an homage kind of like to the Activision games where like you can open up like all these different suits for Spider-Man to swing around in. So.
For sure. Well, you got it, man. So you're going to experience it all.
Mm-hmm. But
I haven't played Red Dead in a little bit.
I haven't either. I got to.
I have to be in the mood to play that game. That game is very slow.
Yes.
It's beautiful. It's great.
No,
awesome game, but I have to be in the mood for it.
Yeah, because I was curious about that. I seen the, I guess the first one, seemed to move a little bit quicker in the story.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing wrong with this one because I'm like, I'm in experience everything. But yeah, I think I might have one more mission before I guess chapter two is over.
Okay. Oh, shit. Okay. Yeah.
I think. Nice. I'm not sure. But yeah, I've done a couple of like side missions and been just trying to figure out stuff. But killed the fuck out of that bear.
Yeah. I finally did too. I used your strategy.
Nice. Did it work?
Boulders are your friend.
Can he climb rocks?
No, he didn't climb a rock.
Fuck yeah.
I was like, I wish you could kind of climb a rock because then it'd be like, all right, this is going to be like a challenge.
Yeah, yeah.
But I was just like, pop, 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 popcorn. And he was like, done.
Yeah. I made the mistake. I gave it to my fur to a trapper. I don't know if I should have done that.
I thought I did. I did the same thing, too.
Okay. Because as soon as you get it, they're all like, oh, go ahead and take it to this trapper.
Yeah.
I'm like, fuck you, old man.
Well, then you get like the different things where it's like, okay, so you can get this outfit and you need the legendary bear and all this stuff. And I was like, okay, so I sold it to you. Does that mean like you have it forever? And so like it covers all these different things?
Yeah, that's
or do I need to have like multiple legendary bears?
Yeah, I feel like they're, some of the tutorials is not the best.
Because
there was a part where like I replayed. Because I went back because I was like, I just kept shooting people in the face by accident.
That's
I was
right,
like, hi,
right.
I want to ask you a question. Oh, God. I was like,
I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry.
This is not Assassin's Creed. You do not use this button to target people. Okay. Fuck me.
That's funny.
So I started the game and I wasn't that far. So I was like, whatever. So I got back, you know, farther and I did a lot better. Obviously, I went after the bear because the last time I just went back with, I think, Hutch.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, I was like, yeah, let me fuck the bear. See, let me try my best. So I was all like, I looked, I found it. I was like, all right, I'm going to get the rifle. Let me see if I can climb up somewhere. So I shot it and I thought it was going to run at me, but it ran away. And I was like, ah, fuck, I'm probably going to have to hunt this thing down. And then it stopped. I shot again and it started charging at me. And then I was like, oh shit.
Yeah.
So I didn't get that far to the rock to climb. So I was like, okay, well, I can tell Matthew to get on a rock, but I don't know if it can climb or not. So hopefully he doesn't jump on the rock and then it's too close that it actually climb. Because then you'd be like, I went on the rock, fucker, no. And I die. Like,
no, I wouldn't have said that. No, I was like on the rock and he was right there. And I was just like, Deadeye, pop, 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 pop. And I was like,
oh, you did smart. You did Deadeye.
Yeah, then he just went down.
I didn't even think to do that.
And I was like, that wasn't so legendary.
Yeah. So, yeah. Yeah, I'm curious about that, too, where you're like, I trade in this thing of, like, can I get this stuff? Can I not get this stuff?
Right.
I don't have half this stuff. Like,
there's still so much game we have, man.
I know.
Things like 60 hours. But, like, I mean, it is pretty cool just kind of, like, trotting down the, like, wilderness roads and, like, looking around. I've been, like, trying to do a lot of hunting with the bow. Try to get, like, perfect pelts and stuff. It's a cool game, but I've been jumping back into Stardew Valley, dude.
Okay, yeah, your brother mentioned that. He got it for the Switch.
He got it for the Switch, dude, and he's dominating. Like,
oh yeah, he was like, oh, I can do this, and I'm like,
he's like, I'm like, what? I mean, Megan plays it too, and Megan's farther than me, and she's doing good as well. But like, my brother's like, whoa, dude, he got this game, and he's a huge Harvest Moon fan.
See, I never played Harvest Moon.
And so, like, he took this game and went running, dude, like, straight for the fucking hills. He was like, ah, like, robbed a bank and ran.
well, he can on the Switch. You can just take it on the go.
So he's been doing that. So I've been jumping back into it. It's a fun game, you know, old school 8-bit, like, 16-bit.
No, I love that kind of stuff. 16-bit, I got that Octopath Traveler.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, I already clocked 20 hours into that thing. Yeah. I could get back into that.
So I've been, Red Dead's kind of been on the
back burner.
The back burner, which I feel bad about, but I gotta be, in the.
No, I agree with you because I'm sitting here, I'm between like this is so weird with me. So I have, you might have this since you do have like two consoles.
Yeah. Yes.
Okay. So I pick a few games. So like I'm like, okay, I got Red Dead.
Yes.
I got Odyssey, which I still haven't started, and then I got Origins.
Okay.
So basically, it's like, okay, if I dive back into Origins, which again, certain games I have to be in the mood for.
Right.
So you dive into Origins, I'm like, okay, but if I get stuck in Origins, but I still want a game, I have two other games I can jump to. So I got Red Dead or I got Odyssey. So I'm like, all right. Same with the Switch. It's all like, okay, what do I got to play? I got the Mario Rabbits right now, but of course, you know, Smash Bros. Is coming out, so I'm like, most of my time is going to probably be spent on that once I get that, which I already did the
pre-order. I mean, we're so close to it.
Yeah, I already did the pre-order.
When is it?
7th.
Oh my gosh, we're so close.
Yeah. Yeah, because this weekend was Pokemon.
Yes.
The two Pokemon games came out back-to-back. And then, the 7th. Nintendo is smart. They released, they released that this week, the Detective Pikachu trailer. And then, we're going to drop our game this week. And you're like, oh, you fucking geniuses. Yeah. And then PlayStation's like, hey, we're going to release our classic system on Monday. And then Nintendo's like, yeah, Smash Bros. Is coming out on Friday. So suck my dick.
Suck my dick.
I already pre-ordered it. I got the Piranha downloaded thing already. I got everything set up for Smash Bros.
What do you mean Piranha download?
Oh, if you buy the game between now and before, like, I think February, you get the Piranha character. Piranha plant character that's exclusive to, like, first members. Yeah, it's Piranha plant. You haven't seen this yet?
I didn't know Piranha.
Oh, shit.
I didn't know the Piranha plant was a character.
Oh, he is now. He's never been. This is his first day. Oh, okay, I gotta show you the video. People lost their fucking minds when this shit dropped.
Yeah, that's great. Piranha's like, such a staple.
They were like, holy fucking shit.
Piranha's... We grew up with Piranha.
Yeah, Piranha plants? Fuck yeah, we did.
We love me some Piranha plants.
But yeah.
So here's the thing. I've never really owned a Smash Brothers game. I've never...
Oh, you're missing out, my friend.
I know. I played them, but I've never, like, owned them. So, I mean, I could get this one, but...
No.
I'm just going to get my ass kicked online, dude.
No.
You going to train me?
I can train you, but I'm also going to say this is the one to buy.
Because it has everything?
It has everything, and not only does it have everything, it actually has a story mode.
Oh, that's right.
So you could actually bounce through and be like, oh, I'm learning things as I go, blah, 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 and then... Like, yeah, if you want some training, I can give you some training.
Oh, shit, man. You might have to coach me.
Like, it's not just a battle royale game. Now, this is the problem that's happened. So when the first one came out, it was just a fighting game. Yes. Worked out perfect. There was a little bit of a story, but not, like, major or anything. It was just, like, point A to point B to beat, like, these matches, fight this weird, stupid hand thing,
yes.
Blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, okay.
Then the melee kind of, nothing too major, a little bit of some stuff. But then Brawl is when they designed a actual story mode. And Brawl was like for the Wii. The Wii had this huge story, like all the characters. That's when, like, you know, I think Solid Snake was in it. You know, all this kind of shit was like, oh, all this stuff. Then they did the Wii U version, which was kind of back to the standard fighting game. Nothing too major. But then they had the DLC characters, and that's when we got like Final Fantasy characters, Bayonetta. So this one's like, okay, we're gonna give you everything. And we're going to give you a new storyline.
Nice.
And their storyline is like almost like the Avengers right now, where it's like everyone's wiped out, and you're like, what the fuck?
Yeah, you have to like rescue them or something like that. Okay.
So it's like, okay, so you can play through that, and I'm pretty sure you're going to kick out of it. So
I'm sure I would.
But yeah, no, I was just like, fuck it, I'm doing the whole... I just did the digital download. So I think I did like the $80 one, so I'm getting all the DLCs. And Nintendo... So even if you just bought the game, and you're like, oh, I'll get the DLC when I want it. I think they're going to sell the DLC for, I think it was 24, maybe 20. But this is what they told everybody. Only buy the DLC if you feel like it's worth it.
They're just real.
Yeah, they're just all like, if you feel like you want this content, then get it. If you don't want this content, then don't worry about it.
Yeah.
It's not going to affect, like... And it's funny because somebody, like, I think IGN put out an article going like, I think Nintendo's doing DLC wrong. And everyone was all like, okay, did you even read what you wrote in this article? Because it sounds like Nintendo's the only one that's doing it right, not going... Because I was like, did anyone...
Cramming it down your throat.
Well, not even that, but like how we did with Destiny 2. We were like, we bought this shit.
Yeah, Destiny.
We got the two seasons. We're like, okay, That's it. Yeah. We got it all. And then like, oh, here's the expansion pack that you want.
Destiny fucked us, dude.
And you're like, okay, fuck you. Which, if they have a good Black Friday sale on that thing, that's when I'll get it. I'm only paying $10 for that shit. I'm sorry.
They fucked us, man.
They fucked us.
Yeah.
So, and then what I love, they turned around, Destiny turned around going like, Activision going like, they're unhappy with everyone's reaction. I'm like, well, yeah, because you fucked us.
It's like lesson learned, man. It's like Battlefront, all the bullshit with Battlefront.
Yeah, it's like, so to me, I'm like, I think Nintendo's, to me, it's like, if you want to play the story game, great. If you want this additional content, you can get it. But it's like when you kind of put like certain things on it where it's all like, well, if you don't get this, you won't get to experience this, this, and this. And you're like, well, shouldn't that have just been in the game anyway?
It's really interesting because like us as gamers and everything that's evolved from it. All right. So, yes, we understand that companies need to make money. So you have DLC and all that stuff. Would we like a game that's quote unquote complete when we get it? Yeah, that'd be great. But, all right, so you're going to give us extra content. If you want to buy into it, you can. That's your choice. Be it as you may.
Yeah.
Models like Destiny 2, I'm bitter about it because you're absolutely correct. When that game came out, we talked about it. We were like, all right, you want to get the base game? Should we do like the deluxe, or should we just go for
the big thing?
And you and I sat and we had a conversation. We were like, fuck it. We both really enjoyed Destiny.
Yeah. We
played hours out of it.
And we got everything.
Yes.
Like, we bought all the expansions. We're like, this is fantastic. We like this.
So let's go big. And we did it.
Uh-huh.
And we spent $100 on the game.
On $100 on this game.
So we play it. We do our stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And then The Forsaken comes out. And I'm like, sweet, man.
Yeah, I was like
pumped to download it. And all of a sudden, it's like, no, you got to pay $30, $40 extra dollars to get this.
Oh, no, not even. The 30 is the base one. Then you have one that's like a $59 one. And then you had another one that was like a $79 one for this fucking DLC. No joke. Because I remember seeing regular, deluxe, and ultra. And I was like, oh, you're really going to try to put more money on this shit? Fuck you.
Like, we didn't even get the base game, dude. Like, we should at least got the base game.
Uh-huh.
Like,
I think that's a disrespect, especially for people who bought it day fucking one or pre-ordered that shit.
Yeah.
Like, that's what I feel like a lot of gaming companies do shaft people. Like, such as with fucking Fallout 76. They're like, oh, if you pre-order, you get the beta. But then the beta was like, oh, 1 o'clock on a Tuesday, log in. And you're like, what the fuck is this?
Yeah, it's the only time you can play it. Yeah.
And you're like, okay. Like, I feel like a lot of, like, that's why I think it's so weird that if people jump on, like, certain people where I'm like, I think Nintendo right now is doing smart. They made an affordable console that you can take anywhere.
Well, I mean, they made the practical choice, too. They just coming out with a statement of, if you want it, great. If you don't, cool.
Exactly. They're giving a,
it's there if you want.
But that's the thing. They've given us a new game every week. Like, whether or not it comes to actual console, like, stores, or if it's actually, like, an indie game, Nintendo has been pushing out a game, like, every week.
Oh, well yeah. I mean, I would assume that all platforms have been doing that.
Not really, because you mostly see most of these indie games get released at, like, sporadic times. Now, a lot of these games, yes, have already been out before, but Nintendo's like, oh, we're now getting the indie license, let's put it out. What I'm basically saying is Nintendo is keeping people interested. And then they give you, oh, you want to do your online? $20. Oh, not only is it $20 if it's just for you or if you want to do your family for like 34, let's give you free games every month. So you can play
lesson
some.
Lesson learned. When
it renewal comes out.
I haven't gotten it yet, but when yours and my brother's expired, we should just.
Yeah, we'll do that.
We should just do a family thing.
Yeah.
It makes sense.
It does make sense. But it's like Nintendo seems to like. Give you, it's like, to me right now with this console, there it's like, okay, I'm agreeing with a lot of stuff they're doing, because it's also like, okay, yeah, Diablo, don't get me wrong, I was like, I kind of want to get Diablo for the Switch.
My brother's getting it,
and I was like, even though I've already played Diablo on the 360 and stuff like that, but I'm like, that thing on the go, that'd be kind of fun. Yeah.
He was texting me last night. He was he's been conflicted about getting Pokemon.
Okay. Such and as like, I brought that up to you. I was like, are you getting Pokemon?
I don't know yet.
I'm,
I want to wait. I, you know, I've seen reviews and it's gotten good reviews. It's just different now because they have the element of Pokemon Go.
Yes.
With the element of Pokemon the game, and they blended them together.
Yes.
So he texted me yesterday and was like, you know, I was thinking about getting the Eevee edition, but it kind of pisses me off that, like, if you want to catch the Pokemon, it's just like Pokemon Go. It's not like you have to battle them and then catch them.
Oh, like you have to be like.
Yeah, so you just catch them, and then to battle, you have to, like, go after trainers or people in the world and all that stuff. It's not like you're out. Because you can. Another thing is, when you're out in the world, you actually see the Pokemon. It's not like you're walking through the grass and all of a sudden it's like. Yeah, exactly. You just see them. So you just walk up to them and be like, okay, well, I'm going to try to catch you.
Okay, so
it's different.
That's weird, yeah. But I know they have been in talks with an actual full-fledged Pokemon game that's going to be coming in either next year or 2020. I want to say 2019 because I remember they talked about this one. And yeah, because you can take your phone and everything like that, and you can use all of the Pokemon.
And you can exchange it. You can take from your phone and put it in the game.
Which is cool and stuff. Like, it's interesting to me, but I'm also kind of like, all right, let me see how many other people.
That's where I'm at. That's why.
So that's why I checked. Well, basically, I was just checking with you because I'm all like, if whichever one you're going to get, I'm going to get the opposite so we can do that bullshit.
Which is throwback.
Yeah.
But like, I told him, I was like, okay, just kind of look at reviews, check out Metacritic, and just see people's like opinions on it. Like, maybe don't go day one. He was like, yeah, that sounds good. Well, I'm going to get Diablo, and I was like, sounds good. Like,
yeah, go with Diablo.
Yeah. So. I think he's going to jump into that, which would be cool. Again, I've got Diablo on the Xbox and love it. I think we played it like once or twice.
Yeah, I still got to get that the expansion to
Necro. Yeah, me too. Maybe we should just switch it up.
You want to go back to Diablo, man? Because my fucking...
Well, here's the thing. So if it's got online multiplayer and like my brother could be in there too... That would be a different element. Because normally when we play, dude, it's you and I.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? And like honestly, we haven't done that in a long time. No. I think the real last time was Gears.
Gears, which we got it.
I know, we still have to finish that.
I forgot, you're going to be... Just bring your Xbox on vacation.
Oh, I think I'm going to bring my Switch. I think I'm going to bring my Switch.
Oh, shit, yeah. We could probably play some... Oh, maybe I should gotta get the...
Album. Well, I mean...
We'll figure it out.
Yeah. I'm like... Hold on, guys. I gotta play with Steve.
Say, I wanted to go back to the Xbox because I know my character is like fucking badass right now. Because
What were you?
I was a I did one of the new ones because when I first played, I was a rogue, or nice. Like the Night Stalker or whatever.
Yeah.
I think I went with the Paladin. I think it was one of the new ones that like when you I think there was like a Necromancer with the expansion pack. Like, because when you bought it for the three, when the Xbox One came out, it had the first DLC along with the game. And then the
Monk?
Yeah, there was a Monk.
I think the Monk's in the original game, though.
Yeah, Monk's in the original. Barbarian's in the original.
Maybe it is the Paladin.
Yeah, it's got to be the... I'll have to look it up.
Yeah, I want Barbarian.
Is it a Paladin or the Crusader?
Crusader.
It might have been the Crusader.
Crusader.
That's what I... Because I played as the Night Stalker, I think, was in my 361. I absolutely love that character.
The Witch Doctor?
No, it's like the they call it the rogue or the hunter.
With the crossbows?
Yeah, the crossbows.
Yeah.
So I played that on my first like one, the 360, because I bought the game twice. I was like, I really fucking dig this.
Right.
And then it came out for the Xbox One. I was like, oh, and I realized it was a lot easier on the Xbox One than it was on the 360. So they changed some stuff when it transferred over. But then I was like, oh, let me try the Crucible.
I should fucking read down.
Yeah, I just have to
download it.
The disc.
Civ 5, Civ 6 is coming out on Civilization. Sid Meier's.
I think the only one I've ever played was number 2.
You never played Civilization Revelation?
I've never played any of the newer ones.
Oh man, it was a free download. You didn't download it?
I probably do have it. I probably did download
it. If you do, you should play it. It's great.
Is it? Okay.
Oh, it's so much fun. I love it. I love those games. But it's either 5 or 6 that is coming out on Switch.
Okay.
And depending on how that does, it'll probably come out on PlayStation and Xbox.
Nice, yeah, yeah. Well, I think like the handheld stuff aspect really like helps it out though, because it's like even me, I'm all like, where are we going? Can I take this with? Like,
you know, I really haven't really done my Switch portable, to be honest. I've done handheld. I just dock it though.
I always dock it, but I have taken it like early ages of like Zelda. I would be like, I want to keep playing. So I would, and then take it to the John with me.
Yeah, but that's what I mean. It's portable. It's not.
I haven't really
taken
it.
It's not like you're leaving your house.
I did take it to Vegas. Oh, you know what? I did take it. Yeah, I took it to Vegas.
Nice.
Pat and I, before Patrick met his lovely fiance.
Right.
Asshole.
No, yeah, good for him.
No, he's so gay. He's like, oh, I'm going to get married again. God.
Good for him, dude. I'm pumped for him.
No, I'm proud for him. I love it. I always give him shit for it because he says me stuff.
Mary, right?
Yeah, Mary.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, he knows. I'm already his. We give each other. I give shit because I always see him like, oh, it's so adorable. And then I just turn over. I'm like, you're so gay. But yeah, no, I took it to Vegas because I remember we got like, he got fucking hung up. That was when we flooded the Monte Carlo.
Yes. Okay.
So he was passed out and stuff and we're just sitting in bed and I was like, well, I brought my Switch. So I just sat there just like playing like Zelda, like, and that's where I collected like a bunch of shit that nice. I was just like for a couple of hours. And I just like had it like hardwired plugged in. And I was all like, yeah, okay. But I just never been like in a place where I'm like, cause usually when you go, so like, I wasn't going to take it to Ireland. Cause I'm all like, yeah, no, Ireland's great. Right. Find that radish, or I can't make this.
I mean, maybe for the flight.
I watched movies though.
Yeah, I did too.
And plus, I was first class in that one. So
that's right. Oh,
that's amazing. That's probably the only time I'm ever gonna get that.
It's all good. Relishing it, dude.
I did.
Yes.
I saw Coco. Good movie.
I still have to see Coco.
You haven't seen Coco?
I haven't seen Coco.
I think it's on Netflix.
It is. Yes.
Definitely
yes,
check it out. Is. You'll like it.
What was I going to say? Mario Party.
Yes.
I don't think you and I can play online.
Really? Do we have to be, like, local?
You have it, right?
Yeah, I have it.
So they have that online play,
uh-huh.
Which has, like, all the mini games. But, like, if I and, like, you know, everybody wanted to jump in
yeah.
and, like, play a board together, I don't think we can do that.
So we can't play a board, but you think all we can do is play mini games?
I think. I don't really know. I haven't done the online yet because I didn't pay the $20 to have
okay,
it.
Okay, I'll look into that this weekend then because I haven't even, like, I remember playing, like, one match.
If we could all play a board, that would be super cool.
That would be fun.
That would be great. That makes sense.
Well, see, this is the thing this is the weirdest part that I had with Mario Party. I bought it and I feel like it's like kind of like the bare bones.
Oh, it's super bare bones. So I'm hoping they're going to release.
I'm wondering if they're thinking of, like, I think
there's only four maps, dude. Four game boards.
And usually, like, they have like what, six or seven, like in the traditional Mario Party games.
I mean, I really hope that they do more because, we haven't unlocked all the like the mini games,
mm-hmm.
So we have all that, but four boards.
Yeah, no, that's what I'm like. It's like I haven't even touched it because I played one board. I'm all like, I'm going to beat all the boards in like one
regardless night. If you're playing tag play or not.
Yeah.
Excuse me, or not.
So, yeah, it seems weird for me because I'm like, we were just talking about, you know, like how good Nintendo's doing. But I felt like Mario Party seems like there's more coming, right?
I hope so. Like more characters?
Yeah, like something. Like, it's just interesting. Because that was like one of those games I'm like, fuck it, I'm just buying it. I'm like, digital.
Dude, it was like day one, and I was like, I love Mario Party. Uh-huh. So I just did it. And so, you know, we were playing and did all this stuff. And it's like, well, another shitty thing is I only have two Joy-Cons, so I need to get two more.
Which sucks because I know you probably did digital, right?
Yeah.
So which sucks because they had that.
I saw that, and I was like, oh, great. I could have just went. It's like $80.
Yeah, and you're like, that would have been. You're like, that's yep. legit because you're like, I think if you buy the Joy-Con separate, it's like what? They're like.
They're $80.
They're $80. So.
Yeah, so well aware.
Yeah. So, yeah, it's like because I was like, I already have the controllers.
Well, did you see that post that Silverman?
Yeah.
He got the Pokemon Switch.
Yeah, you got the Pokemon Switch with the Pikachu with the ball, and then you got the Eevee game.
Yep.
with the ball, and then he got
the Super Mario Party with
Super
the
Mario Party with the Joy-Cons. And the one guy was like, "That's a lot for that." He's like, "Well, I just bought it for the Joy-Cons," and I was all like, "Yeah," because I thought like it was funny because we were talking about that at your party, and we're like, "Well, it's a good thing that we didn't do it because we ended up not like touching the Switch at all." But I was about to ask you, I was like, "Do you want me to bring two Joy-Cons over?"
I thought about it for a second, and then I was like, "Nah."
Yeah, you know,
because we would have been limited. Like, at least with Jackbox, like, multiple people could get
Yeah, you
on
could
that.
Have, like, what, eight people on that? Seven or something? So, and this would only have been, like, four.
Four to do that or jump into Mario Kart.
Yeah, so still it's the like... four.
But I did think about it for a second, too.
No, like, I like that idea with that kind of stuff with the party games, but it's also kind of like... But I did like some of the new mini games.
There's some fun ones.
Like, using the Joy-Cons and stuff. So it's like, so it's still fun, but it's also kind of like... I know Mario Party 1 had more content than this, yeah. Which that better be on the small N64.
We'll see.
You think they're going to have 64 games on it?
I don't think they're going to have 64 games on it, no.
I think they should.
I think that would be cool, but I do not think that's going to happen.
Well, I think they'll have more games in PlayStation, so.
I would say that. How much came on the SNES? Was it 30?
Yeah, so the first one was 30. Second one was 32.
32, okay.
So this one probably, what, 34, you think? Maybe they just keep upping it.
38.
Yeah, because that's the thing. Like they have a lot.
38.
Like there's a lot. Like you know, Mario 64. Boom, that's a staple.
Absolutely.
Ocarina of Time. Boom.
Yes.
Star Fox 64.
Yes. Super Mario 64. Wave Race.
Wave Race. Yeah.
I wonder Pilot Wings.
I would assume Pilot Wings because that is Nintendo licensed. Like the one I'm weary about is
Paper Mario.
Yeah, definitely Paper Mario. Like Shadow of the Empire.
See, that one's a question mark.
That's
for
a question
me.
Mark for me too, because it's like
the license.
The license.
If it's on there, I'd be fucking stoked.
I'd be fucking stoked. Yoshi's Story.
Yes.
Probably one of the Mario parties.
Yeah, I don't know about one though. Maybe two or three.
That's what I'm thinking. I think they're gonna go with three, which is weird because I like one the best.
Pokemon Snap.
They probably will, which I'm not too excited about because I didn't like that game. It was okay. What was the one I was thinking of? Blast Core. Oh, that might be a licensing too because it's rare.
Yeah, but it's already out on the Rare Replay.
That's true. Do you think Banjo-Kazooie?
I mean, they could.
Smash Bros.
Yes. Well, yes, because that's the only one on there, right?
Yeah.
On the 64?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. I would say yes then.
Maybe Majora's Mask. Not sure.
That would be cool.
I'm trying to think.
I've never played that.
I'm trying to think what other. Oh, either Turok 1 or 2.
Maybe. Maybe.
Maybe.
I mean, that's.
I mean, it is a claim.
Goldeneye's
got it. That's rare. No, it's got to be on there.
It's got to be on there.
It was on Rare. It's a Rare game, though. Isn't that so weird? That's the one thing I'm curious about, though, is Diddy Kong Racing. Oh, Mario 64, of course.
Yeah, we said that.
Oh, we did say Mario Kart 64? Okay, but Diddy Kong Racing.
Oh, I would love that.
Donkey Kong 64.
Absolutely.
Okay, I say if Donkey Kong 64 is on there, at least...
Donkey Kong Country, you mean?
No, Donkey Kong... Well, it's Donkey Kong 64, I think it was called. Maybe it is Donkey Kong Country 64. I remember it's a yellow cartridge, had that DK wrap.
Yeah, I thought it was just Donkey Kong Country.
No, there's Donkey Kong Country. That was for the Super Nintendo. Mm. And then they did a 64 version.
Oh, maybe it was that.
Yeah. That was like, DK, Donkey Kong.
Boom.
Yeah, that's definitely... If that's going to be on there, then definitely Banjo-Kazooie 1. It's got to be on there. Because that was a huge, like, staple.
They
Conker's Bad Fur Day. Do you think that makes it? I'm going to say no.
I don't think...
Wait, well, what is GoldenEye? Is that teen or is that M?
I thought that was Oh, GoldenEye? I
think it's rated. M. If it's M?
Was there blood?
Yeah.
It's M. I don't know.
Okay, that's the thing. If it's M, then Conker's Bad Fur Day's on it.
Let's see.
Because I know Conker's Bad Fur Day was a mature one. But I can't remember if GoldenEye was teen or...
It was teen. It was teen.
But I know if they put Perfect Dark on there, because Perfect Dark was... That was M, right? Do you think they put South Park on there?
The one with the snowball? I know. That game sucks.
Dude. I know. That'd be that'd be amazing.
That'd be kind of funny.
Like, they just go to Trey Parker Mets, and they're like, can we just put them? They're like, yeah. In fact, take them all.
They're like, please.
Actually, you know what would be a fun one to have, actually, and this is a great party game, is Chef's Love Shack.
Dude, so that one, like, I've only played that maybe one or two times.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, that was a fun one. So it actually went back to, like, the traditional, like, style of the characters. They actually kind of, I think, kind of took the Mario Party effect to it, where they made it like it had a trivia aspect of it and then a bunch of mini games and you had to go through and play. Oh, yeah, that was fun. Yeah, that was a weird, like, time for South Park. They did, like, three or four video games. I know they did the original South Park game. Then they did, what did they do? I'm trying to find all this stuff right now. I know there was the original South Park game. Then they did South Park, like Teen Racing. Then I think they did, Chef's Love Shack. And that might have been it before they did anything else. Cause I remember it came out, let's see. Okay, so we did, yeah, the original South Park. These came out in 1998. Then we had South Park Love Shack. Then there was also the South Park Rally. Then there was South Park Let's Go.
Let's Go Pikachu.
Let's Go Tower Defense.
Yeah, which, I remember that.
Then there was a South Park game for the Xbox Arcade at some point.
And then let's jump to the good ones.
And then, Stick of Truth. Then Stick of Truth, and then the newest one.
Fracture Butthole.
Fracture Butthole. Well, yeah, no, I was remembering, like, yeah, but Chef's Love Shack was the one that came back to, like, it was looked like the show.
Yeah.
Everybody was like, but then it was like almost like Mario Party where you would do trivia questions and stuff, and then you would play all these mini games.
Yeah.
And that was actually kind of fun. But yeah, I remember the very first one with, like, the chicken gun and, like, the aliens. And then it was just the battle mode.
Anal probe.
Yeah.
Remember Tony Hawk Pro Skater?
Oh, fuck yeah, I remember Tony Hawk Pro Skater.
So, yesterday, before I went to my meeting, I was like, dude, I've had this song in my head. I just want to play it. So I looked up the tab for it. I learned how to play this song on guitar. I think it'd be fun to play.
Down on the sidewalk, you struggle, grasp your nightshirt and turn. But the universe doesn't say what you wanted to say.
I love this song.
The universe says just what it says, when it says what it says. But on the planet Earth, spinning around its axis, revolving around the sun, revolving around the center of the Milky Way galaxy and a super cluster of galaxies, will it ever be you and me?
Song's like super easy to play.
Oh yeah.
But like you just gotta like the timing. There's one part where I get like tripped up on my fingers, but you remember this track?
Oh yeah.
The Ernies, dude.
What you wanted to say, the universe says just what it says. When it says what it says, but on the planet Earth, spinning around its axis.
Yeah, it's a super fun track.
Oh yeah, man. I think that was a big like thing they missed out on that PlayStation Classic was Tony fucking Hawk.
Oh my gosh, dude. Those soundtracks are like
legit.
They're dude, I learned about so many different bands and rap groups and,
yeah, because you would jump on and be like, oh, I like this track, who does
yeah,
it? And
who
then
is
you'd
it?
Be like, you'd go to the store, oh fuck, there's a song, and then you'd be like, oh shit,
oh yeah. And I thought it was great that like you could pause and like go and like queue up songs or like play this track right now, man.
I think the coolest thing was also when you had like an Xbox. Yeah, like think the first Xbox, you could like burn your CDs onto the hard drive. Even the
360 could do it.
And then boom, you could play like your own tracks. Games.
Yeah.
That was so much fun.
I learned about so many.
Played so much Tony Hawk, listened to Weird Al.
Dude.
Okay, so I saw you were interested.
I am interested.
In the Weird Al concert.
Yeah, I'm interested.
So
I'm interested, man. And it's got like the strings and stuff. It's different. Yeah. I'm interested.
Kind of want to go.
Okay. I'm open to it for sure.
Like, I was like, I think you should go. It'd be fun.
Yeah, I think it'd be fun too. It's coming up here quick though, right?
No, August.
August?
It's August 2019.
Oh, we good.
Yeah, that's what I was like. But I'm like, birthday weekend.
Oh, shit. Because what up? Yeah, that's right.
That's what I saw. I was all like, Matthew interested in Weird Al, because I like in my head I'm like,
you're like, that doesn't make sense.
That doesn't make sense. Matthew likes other music.
That doesn't make sense. No, I was intrigued by this one. That's funny. Are you saying that I can't evolve, dude?
No, I think it's great because I know Eric and I have that bond of like, oh yeah, we like Weird Al, and you're like, oh yeah.
That'd be cool if Eric could come out.
Maybe if he's sober.
Love you.
No, just kidding. Yeah, no, we should look into that. That'd be fun.
That'd be cool.
I think you get a kick out of that. We can get all Weird Al shirts.
Okay, slow down, dude.
Don't you take this from me.
Number one fan.
He's number two and he's number three.
Ooh.
Think about Cornfield.
Oh, shit. I haven't been on this track in a long time.
Oh, shit. Where are you going to bounce at?
Oops, my bad. They need to bring these games back, dude. I sunk so many hours into these games.
Sit there and be like,
yeah, dude. Indie.
Psycho. Fish hat. Fuck you.
That's what I used to say.
Fuck you.
What about?
Oh, shit.
I can see if I had, dude. I'm just going to say right now, I love me from some fucking Zebrahead, dude.
Oh,
I have for years.
Oh.
Never seen him.
I've never seen him either.
I don't really remember this one. Black Ball by Offspring.
Yeah, it's like, I know it's Offspring. I've just.
What about this one?
I wrote the word. Let me know where it came from. Open it up.
Who's this?
You got this, dude.
Do I got this? I don't know. I'm feeling Bad Religion.
From the infirmary. Blink 182.
It is?
This isn't Blink, but From the Infirmary.
From the Infirmary.
Is the album.
Okay.
And I'm going to say Blink 182 as a reference. A song on the back of a photograph. Behind
your back it goes. A little something like this. I have no idea.
Skiba?
No.
It's not Alkaline Trio.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. This does not even sound like him.
What about this one?
They were on a Tony Hawk?
One of the second or third ones.
Huh. Which one?
Maybe I haven't heard this album Slunk.
Oh, yeah.
Pastor's been time. Dude, Authority Zero, dude. Hometown Boys.
I need a remedy! Of diesel and dust. Something I can taste with a fix I can trust. Another high. My potent lies. Eating and I'm appealing like the way in a glass of time.
Oh, they got Rise Against on here? Dude, speaking of Rise Against, so whenever I go in my car, like I start it up and I've got all AZ on,
mm-hmm.
and they'll play this Rise Against song. I think this is it, House of Fire, off their new album, The Ghost Note Symphony is Volume 1.
Okay, yeah.
The intro of this song, when I hear it, I'm just like, gets me pumped. I hope this is the one. Let's see. Hello?
Hello?
Oh, you
got this?
It doesn't want to work now.
Oh.
Do you want to try doing it?
Yeah.
Right. Oh, sorry, bud.
No, I got it.
Rise Against.
Rise Against the Ghost of...
But no. Not that song.
Oh, it's just playing whatever it felt like, apparently. I didn't even click on it. It's like, oh, Rise Against, here's their song.
Did you want to listen to Rise Against?
Which one was it? House on Fire?
Yeah.
Okay.
Let's do that one. Oh, I can see the storms. No, that's not it.
Okay, well, that says that's the House on
that's
Fire.
That's not one. It. Oh, wait. Maybe go check up the album Wolves.
Oh.
Wait, maybe don't do anything. I'm sorry, dude. Maybe there's like a new single or something.
Anyways. House on Fire, Wolves.
Maybe we could try it.
Is this it? What?
Oh, no. Falling overboard in the waves, in over my head, and she's a high tide. I don't know.
Yeah,
man.
It's Rise Against Wolves. There's also the song Wolves.
Yeah, that was it. You're right. We're not doing too good on the music right now. That's okay, though. You know, it's okay.
Is it?
Yeah, I'm not upset by it. We've talked about it before, man. We both support Spotify. If you want to listen to the show, go to Spotify on the podcast app tab and look up Socially Awkward Studios. Although the desktop version, not as efficient as the mobile version.
It is not. Get on that. Spotify.
we love you, and we love being on your platform. I just don't understand it, man.
I would assume the desktop would be better. But maybe it's not because they figure everybody's mostly using their mobile devices. Which you know what should get Spotify is the Switch.
Yeah, dude, get on that Switch.
That'd be amazing.
Cutting the ties.
Bing, bing.
Ball's dropped.
What's that song?
All right, dude, you want to go get some food?
Yeah, we can wrap up this episode. Well, Matthew, I hope you...
Oh, I'm sorry. I have one last question.
Oh, go right ahead.
With Thanksgiving coming up next week, and if anybody's still listening, or they made it through the episode and they're listening right now...
You are doing the gauntlet.
You guys, we appreciate
you're
you.
You're the real heroes.
What are you thankful for, man?
I am thankful...
Or this, you know, this year, this time, whatever. What makes you thankful right now?
Friends... Family, and just, you know what? It's been shitty weeks, but I would have to say I think there's a lot more good weeks that weigh out the shitty weeks. So just in general, just life is good.
I like that. I like that.
How about you?
Yeah, man. Family, friends, support system, and yeah, I agree. You know, life is good. And, yeah, I'm thankful for that.
Shit happens, but you know what? Some pretty cool shit happens, too.
I'm thankful for you.
I'm thankful for you, Matthew.
Touch my hand.
So I want to thank everybody for joining us on this Stan the Man Lee episode, but also Thankmas.
Yeah. Thanks, Miss. Oh, we didn't even get into that.
But oh, it's all right. We got... Black Friday episode. We'll see how that counts out.
Oh, man.
I might just be, Anyways, but yeah, I want to thank everybody for hanging out with us tonight.
Absolutely.
And I know maybe there'll be a show next week, but if we don't hear or see or whatever, everybody have a great, fun Thanksgiving or whatever you celebrate. Just spend time with your family.
Love it.
If you like doing the Black Friday deals and that's your thing,
good luck to you.
Just be safe.
Don't trample people.
Yeah, just be safe.
It's not worth it.
But yeah, so Matthew, unless you have anything else you'd like to add.
Steve, unless you have anything else you would like to add.
I think we should add two things.
We're going
to tap.
We're going to tap.
You know, that's Sam.
That's Sam, man.
Fuck this shit, I'm out. Fuck this shit, I'm out. No thanks, don't mind me. I'ma just grab my stuff and leave. Excuse me, please. Fuck this shit, I'm out. Nope. Fuck this shit, I'm out. Alright then. I don't know what the fuck just happened, but I don't really care. I'ma get the fuck up out of here. Fuck this shit, I'm out.